And like Kendrick, like he got misled. Oh, like right now, it seems like.
Emery, diss tracks on Twitch poll, bro. No receipts necessary.
Now that stuff is like discrediting like Kendrick a little bit, especially with like the wife beater allegations. That kind of line doesn't age as well if he's like bragging about, yeah, I got moles in your like circle.
Yo,
like,
Phillies, that's this white boy stripe, man.
Oh my god.
He fooled you. How does that not make
because
him look
who puts
bad?
Out a fake who puts out fake propaganda on
it's
having
rap,
a fake daughter?
No rules. Of course they're gonna do that. What are you talking about?
Oh, now there's no rules. Not so why are there rules for Kendrick and not for Drake?
I don't know, but like that's the point.
Would you
point.
Say Drake it's has more fans than Kendrick? Just read the comments. Not that the comments matter, but like if you're trying to gauge how people are judging this battle, go under Drake's own video and read the comments. You go on the offense. We talked about this yesterday, bro. That's not how you win a rat battle, dog. Gotcha.
No, you're just objectively wrong.
Calm down. All right, chill. Bro, I literally listened to everything you said. Can you just shut the fuck up for a second?
You haven't listened to me at all.
I love when people do this part. This is like the funnest part of the conversation. Just go, bro. Go. I get what
you're
saying.
You can't be objective. You're slobbering Kendrick's dick so much.
Listen, anything up.
You're failing.
You are further than you. You're beyond dead. You are not only dead, your entire soul was like annihilated from existence.
Okay, first of all, Kendrick works with sex offender. I don't want to hear
who? He didn't bring up Millie Bobby Brown, but Drake must have a fucking guilty conscience because Drake brought up Millie Bobby Brown.
Okay, so if there's no verifiable fact.
We already knew the culture vulture shit. Like that's been like
fucker. Emery.
We've
dude,
already been knew that. And that's not new information.
Nice to you right now,
no one
but
cares.
Make you want to know.
Okay, I started listening to this shit yesterday on the way to Connecticut. So I had heard about it. I don't listen to a lot of music anymore. Listen to a lot of talk shit. But these guys talking shit was kind of good. Sticking to the code, all these holes for the street. I'm probably going to get my stream nuked. With this one? Okay, yeah, you're probably right. The rest, I think I'm all right with. The rest should be cool. All right. I'm conflicted about the most recent one. I'm very conflicted. Your first number one, I had to put it in your hand. You pussies can't get booked outside America for Nan. I'm out in Tokyo because I'm big in Japan. I'm the hit maker, y'all depend on. Backstage in my city, it was friend zone. You won't never take no chain off of us. How the fuck you big stepping with a size 7 man zone? This the part with the bite, nigga. Looks good right now. I know my picture on the wall when y'all cook up. Extortion, baby, whole career, you been shook up. Cause top told you drop it, give me 50 likes or push ups. Hood, your last one brick, you really not on shit. They make excuses for you cause they hate to see me lit. Pull your contract cause we gotta see the split. The way you doing splits, bitch, your pants might rip. You better do that motherfucking show inside the bitty. Maroon 5 need a verse, you better make it witty. Then we need a verse for the Swifties. Top say drop, you better drop and give them 50. I don't know if I agree. Squeak pipe down, you ain't in no big three. Scissor got you wiped down, Travis got you wiped down, Savage got you wiped down. Like your label, boy, you in a scope right now. The one before last fucking banged. That shit just add his talk with your ass. Just, I had a hike down. Big different swing, Mike then and Mike now. What the fuck is this, a 20 V? Just on sound alone. Prince to a king, he a son, nigga. All right. Love in a city that you run, nigga. Metro, shut your whole ass up and make some drums, nigga. Yeah, I'm the sixth guy, I'm the front runner. Y'all nigga manager was Chuz, little blunt runner. Clean a six and you boys ain't even come from it. And when you boys got rich, you had to run from it. Cash blowing, able bread out here tricking. How you tricking? Shit we do for bitches, he doing for niggas. What the fuck? Jets, whips, chains, wicked, 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 wicked.
Spinning like you trying to fuck. Boy, you tripping, boy, you tripping. Drizzy chipping there. Probably got your bitch in there.
Make me at the chipping there. What a screenshot. Stage, I would turn. That was slick as hell. Shit will probably change if it be him. Start to kiss and tell. Hugs and kisses, man. Don't tell me about no switches. Ryan said you were complaining about us.
Yeah, I was.
Bro, we were cucking. What do you mean? We were cucking.
True. No, that's for you to be cucked.
I was like, I'm sitting there, I'm like fucking around doing some shit online, and I hear like bloop bloop bloop. Like, what the fuck, who's moving me around rooms? And I look up and I see him like, oh, smart ass bitch. And then Resto comes in, he's like, yo, what are you doing in here? It's like, oh, just chilling, waiting for Cankle to start streaming. He's like, oh, you got your, where are we? He's like, we're in Cankle's, are we? He's like, oh, you got your own cock lair. I'm like, oh, this motherfucker.
Yeah, I was curious, like, why? I've been here for a while. I don't have a fucking tuck layer or anything.
He was just sitting in it.
Okay, that makes more sense. Money wise, I'm out of here. You're not fucking sneaking up. Corn ball, your show money. Merch money feed us. I'ma let you niggas work it out because
you
play Halo at all, Kingo? Everything I know,
don't wait to demon up. A little bit, not very, very, very rarely. Drop and give me 50, all you fuck niggas teaming up. I used to
get on the I don't know whose it is technically. Neve's thing, maybe? I'm not sure.
Yeah, Pixel Bells is a Neve's thing.
Yeah. Did you see the short she had?
What short?
She has a couple for Halo, but there's one, like, at the very end. She just, like, fucking destroys my ass because we were doing this weird level of, like, grappling hooks on these poles. And I did not know you could pick up explosives. So all we had were swords. So I was literally standing on top of a pole, and she's, like, grappling up to me. And all you hear is, like, me say, get over here, bitch. And then she just throws a bomb in my face. I immediately die. And then she gets up and teabags me.
Nah, you clicked into the screen share, Ron?
Yes, I am.
Okay.
But do you remember when we did the Jackbox games?
Yes.
Yeah, exactly.
My presentation was on how teabagging in Halo changed my life.
Is your life changed?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, after getting teabagged by Neve.
Yeah.
Which one is it?
The poles one, I think. Was it the poles?
Yes, that one right there.
I think it's the poles.
Oh, my God. I hate that Firefox does this. It's the one thing.
Okay, only rockets.
You got unlimited. That's first one. That's up, Neve. Oh, shit. That's pretty good.
I saw that struggle you took.
Really? Oh, I hit you.
Another one off the board. We're two.
I'm gonna be honest, man.
Most negative.
That was the coolest thing I've ever done.
I must have been too close to it.
Can I not go to spawn? Okay. I should have
been there. Yeah, we did.
What
the fuck is that?
That was pretty good. All right. Back to.
Really, really trying to keep it PG. Illuminati does rise again. You can see it in my eyes again.
I only listened to this one once, and I don't remember anything about it.
Kendrick, we need ya, the West Coast savior. Ain't great to your name and some hip-hop history. If you deal with this viciously,
You seem a little nervous about all the publicity. Fuck this Canadian light-skinned doc. We need to know the baby West Coast victory, man. Call him a bitch for me. Talk about him liking young girls, that's a kid for me. Heard it on the button podcast, it's gotta be true. They told me the spirit of Machiavelli is alive, and the nigga under 5'5", so it's gotta be you. I would beat the whole fucking game. It was me and Snoop Dogg, had my fucking shirt off in the House of Blues. K, you gotta fuck this nigga, girl, he gotta get abused. All that shit about burning tattoos, he is not amused. That's jail talk for real thugs, you gotta be you. Gotta leave this motherfucker broken and bruised before we really lose. You asked for the smoke, now I seen you too busy for the smoke. I won't lie, the people confused. Now you about to get this shit another week and fall back to home, girl, but running up was up, I would've refused. For these industry relationships, she not in your shoes. You supposed to be the boogeyman, go do what you do. Unless this is a moment that you tell us it's not really you. In that case, there's nothing left to say, I just pass it to Snow.
Nephew, what the fuck you really got to do? We passed you the torch at the House of Blues, and now you gotta do some dirty work. You know how to move, right? Right? I know you never been to jail, orange jumpsuits and shower shoes. Never shot nobody, never stabbed nobody, never did nothing violent. And no one, it's the homies that empower you. But still, you gotta show this fucking aisle who's boss on the west. Now's the time to really make a power move, cause right now it's looking like you writing out the game plan on how to lose, how to bark up the wrong tree and then get your head popped in a crowded room. World is watching this chess game, but are you out of moves? Dot, you know the DOG never fucking doubted you, but right now it seems like you posted up without a clue of what the fuck you about to do.
Yeah, that's the truth. I'm definitely about to come around the land gang and let my fucking bow move. Shitting on you niggas from a whole different altitude. High up in the sky like I'm Howard Hughes. The first one really only took me an hour or two. The next one is really about to bring out the coward in you. But now we gotta wait a fucking week, cause Taylor Swift is your new top. And if you about to drop, she gotta approve. This girl really about to make you act like you not in a feud. She tailor-made your schedule with Ant, you out of the loop. Hate all you corporate industry puppets, I'm not in the mood. I love it when you niggas talk loose like I'm not in the room. Since like that, your tone changed a little, you not as enthused. How are you not in the booth? It feel like you kinda removed. You tryna let this shit die down. Nah, not this time, nigga, you following through. I guess you need another week to figure out how to improve. What the fuck is taking so long? We waiting on you. The rest of y'all are definitely involved, y'all getting it too. Soon as you get the courage to drop, I'm out on the loose. On the loose. Yeah, shout out to Taylor Swift. Biggest gangster in the music game right now. You know, I moved my album when she dropped. I said that already. You know, she about to mini run, do a milli rock on your head top. But she got the whole PG Lang on mute like that Beyonce challenge. Y'all boys quiet for the weekend. Like, Dot, I know you in that NY apartment. You struggling right now. I know it. In the notepad doing lyrical gymnastics, my boy. You better have a motherfucking quintuple entendre on that shit. Some shit I don't even understand. Like, this shit better be crazy. We waiting on you. Yeah.
Euphoria. Them superpowers getting neutralized. I can only watch in silence. The famous actor we once knew is looking paranoid and now spiraling. You're moving just like a degenerate. Every antic is feeling distasteful. Why calculate you not as calculated? I can even predict your angle. Fabricating stories on the family front, cause you heard Mr. Morale. A pathetic master manipulator. I can smell the tails on you now. You're not a rap artist, you're a scam artist with the hopes of being accepted. Tommy Hilfiger stood out, but FUBU never had been your collection. I make music that electrify them. You make music that pacify them. I can double down on that line, but spare you this time. That's random acts of kindness. Know you're a master manipulator and habitual liar too. But don't tell no lie about me, and I won't tell truth about you.
Shoo! 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 Shoo!
Beep, 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 beep.
Yo,
I'm out the way, yeah, I'm low, okay. Yeah, the island right here is remote, okay. I ain't thinking about no reaper, nigga, I'm reaping what I sow, okay. Got a Benjamin and a Jackson all in my house, like I'm Joe, okay. Hellcat, made his homeboys in them types, LA solo, okay. Everybody wanna be demon till they get chipped by your throwaway. And I might do a show a day. What's a lame? Always a lame. Oh, you thought the money, the power of fame will make you go away. Have you ever played? Have you ever? Okay, nigga, let's play. Have you ever watch your enemy down like with a poker face? Have you ever paid 500,000 like to an open case? Well, I have, and I failed at both, but I came out straight. I hate when a rapper talk about guns, then somebody die, they turn into nuns, then hop online like pray for my city. He faking for likes and digital hugs. His daddy a killer, he wanna be junior. They must have forgot the shit that they done. Dementia must run in his family, but let it get shaky. I park your son. The very first time I shot me a Drake, the homie had told me to aim it this way. I didn't point down enough. Today I show you I learned from those mistakes. Somebody had told me that you got a ring. Oh God, I'm ready to double the wage. I'd rather do that than let a Canadian nigga make pot turn in his grave. Cutthroat business, you got shit twisted. What is it, the brakes? I hurt your feelings, you don't work with me no more. Okay. There's 3 ghosts left, and I see 2 of them kissing and hugging on stage. I love them to death, and in 8 bars I'll explain their phrase. It's nothing nobody can tell me. I don't wanna talk on no celly. You know I got language barriers. It's no accent you can sell me. Your Cole and Ivory know I'm a selfish nigga. The crown is heavy. I pray they my real friends. If not, I'm YNW Melly. I don't like you popping shit at Pharrell. For him, I inherit the beef. Yeah, fuck all that pushing P. Let me see you push a T. You better off spinning again on him. You think about pushing me. He's Terrence Thorne, I'm Terrence Crawford. Yeah, I'm whooping feet. We ain't gotta get personal, this a friendly fade. You should keep it that way. I know some shit about niggas that make gonna wanna look like a saint. This ain't been about critics, not about gimmicks, not about who the greatest. It's always been about love and hate. Now let me say, I'm the biggest hater. I hate the way that you walk, the way that you talk. I hate the way that you dress. I hate the way that you sneak this. If I catch flight, it's gonna be direct. We hate the bitches you fuck, cause they confuse themselves with real women. Then notice I said we, it's not just me, I'm what the culture feeling. How many more fairy tale stories about your life till we had enough? How many more black features till you finally feel that you're black enough? I like Drake with the melodies. I don't like Drake when he act what? Tough. You gon' make a nigga bring back Puff. Let me see if Chubbs really crash something. Yeah, my first one like my last one. It's a classic, you don't have one. Let your core audience stomach that. Then tell them where you get your abs from. V12, it's a fast one. Boom, boom, boom. Last one. Headshot for the year. You better walk around like Daft Punk. Remember? Hey, top dog, who the fuck they think they playing with? Extortion my middle name as soon as you jump off of that plane, bitch. I'm allergic to the lame shit, only you like being famous. Yachty can't give you no swag neither, I don't give a fuck about who you hanging with. I hate the way that you walk, the way that you talk, I hate the way that you dress. Surprise, you wanted that feature request, you know that we got some shit to address. I even hate when you say the word nigga, but that's just me, I guess. Some shit just cringeworthy, ain't even gotta be deep, I guess. Still love when you see success, everything with me is black. Keep making me dance, waving my hand, and it won't be no threat. I'm knowing they call you the boy, but where's the man? Cause I ain't seen him yet. Matter of fact, I ain't even bleed him yet. Can I bleed him? Bet. When I see you stand by Sexy Red, I believe you see 2 bad bitches. I believe you don't like women. It's real competition. You might pop ass with them. Let's speak on percentage. Show me your splits. I'll make sure I double back with you. You assigned to a nigga that signed to a nigga that said he was signed to that nigga. Try cease and desist on a like that record. Oh, what? You ain't like that record? Back to back. I like that record. I'ma get back to that for the record. Why would I call around trying to get turd on niggas? Y'all thinking my life is rap? That's whole shit. I got a son to raise. But I can see you don't know nothing about that. Waking them up, no none about that. Then tell them to pray, no none about that. Then giving them tools to walk through life like day by day, no none about that. Teaching them morals, integrity, discipline. Listen, man, you don't know none about that. Speaking the truth and consider what God's considering. You don't know none about that. Ain't 20v1, it's 1v20. If I gotta smack niggas that right with you, yeah, bring them out too. I clean them out too. Tell Bean that he better stay right with you. Am I battling ghosts or AI? Nigga feeling like Joel Austin. Funny, he was in a film called AI. And my 6 cents telling me to off him. I'ma blick niggas all in the coffin. Yeah, OVO niggas is dick riders. Tell them run to America to imitate heritage. They can't imitate this violence. What I learned is niggas don't like the West Coast, and I'm fine with it. I'll push the line with it. Pick a nigga off one at a time with it. We can be on a 3-hour time difference. Don't speak on the family, Crody. It can get deep in the family, Crody. Talk about me and my family, Crody. Someone go bleed in your family, Crody. I be at Newhall King eating fried rice with a dip sauce and a blimey, Crody. Tell me your cheese and farm. We can do this right now on the camera, Crody. Hey, fuck y'all niggas, I don't trust y'all niggas. I wave one finger and thump y'all niggas like, field goal punt y'all niggas, they punk y'all niggas. Nobody never took my food. Whoever that's fucking with them, fuck you niggas. And fuck the industry too. If you take it there, I'm taking it further. Psst, that's something you don't wanna do. Ooh.
don't wanna hear you say nigga no more. We don't wanna hear you say nigga no more.
Stop. When I heard that part the first time, that fucking killed me. That fucking killed me. That was so funny. It's so good.
These diss tracks have got to be like some of the most heard songs.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Maximus. What bar totally flopped? Wait, or was that something that he just said that I totally just missed? True.
Yeah. There's survival, survival. I think somebody lying.
Yeah, he said the wrong name. I saw that.
I don't see no
yeah.
Fire.
But I wonder if that's what he meant. Like, I wonder if people think it flopped. Hold on. What? Oh.
Ooh. Them lyrics.
Where is it?
Yeah, there's a video I shared last night. It, if you watch it, you get one N-word pass. I'll send it to you.
Very funny.
You only get one N-word pass? Or
yeah, it's a single use.
Okay, so you can't watch it again and get another one.
One like. One like on the video is one N-word pass.
Ah, there we go.
Yeah. I'd advise saving it for a special occasion, like pretty rare, hard to come by.
Yes.
Okay. Kendrick responds to Drake's April 2024 diss track, Taylor Made Freestyle, in which he's AI to create verse for Tupac and Snoop Dogg. Kendrick mocks Drake's use of this technology in his diss track, going on to ask if he's battling either ghosts or robots. Kendrick's implying that when rivaling Drake, he's either coming up against artificial intelligence or Drake's alleged ghostwriters and not Drake himself. Kendrick then appears to rap Joel Hale Osteen, likely because he's focusing on the rhyme scheme of Osteen or Osteen off him. However, he's actually referring to both Joel Osteen and Haley Joel Osment. This may be deliberate, confusing Joel Osteen and Haley Joel Osment to play on the idea that he does not know who he's battling. Joel Osteen is a famous pastor from Houston, Texas. Has famously been impersonated multiple times, including by AI, and he has also been accused of using a ghostwriter. Haley Joel Osment is an American actor who starred in 2001 film AI. And 1999, Sixth Sense, in the latter film. That's a crazy bar. That's fucking insane. That is the craziest. That's wild. That's insanely, that's perfectly coded. You're in Fluffing Room? Oh, shit. Do you not have access?
Emery.
What's up? 1 second. I'm on my phone. I'm driving home.
Oh, all right.
Ideal.
I don't know why it won't let me other. I wanted to put it on speaker. Ooh. I can hear myself. There's a repeat.
Really?
Yeah, I can hear it right now. It's almost like clear as day. That's the funny thing. It's not like an echo.
You have the YouTube video open still?
Yeah, you're right. My bad. I'm fucking retarded. There you go. Did you guys listen to Heart Part 6?
I did.
So,
I'm very mixed.
Yeah, this is what I'm feeling. I feel like on both ends, like this is like an incredibly close match. And the only thing that really makes out like a very, very clear winner, unless you're like a stan and you're slobbering on like one rapper's dick or another. But like a definitive winner is you have to have the receipts. You have to back up these things. Like, so for example, if Drake's making the claim that, hey, like the whole mole thing, that was a fake mole. Like, he has to back that up. But there's like some hints in his track, Family Matters. There's hints to like that being the case already. So like, I'm leaning towards that maybe being the case, but he still has to back it up to make, sell the narrative.
Emery, diss tracks on Twitch Paul, bro. No receipts necessary.
No, that's not true. That's not true. Because if you want to kill somebody officially, you want to like dead them like Kendrick or Drake wants to, or Kendrick especially, you have to have facts to back it up. Like if you want to dead their career, like the elimination of Drake, like everyone's saying, yeah, like you want to provide facts. And like Kendrick, like he got misled. Like right now, it seems like, and that looks bad on him. So that hurts his kind of like word right now.
Disagree.
You don't think that it would make people look at the last Kendrick song a little differently if they proved that Drake clowned him into that shit?
Yeah, that might look at it differently, but reality, to the audience that it's focused to, like, we aren't the audience, dude.
There's another perspective. People might also look at it like Drake clowned himself. Yeah,
yeah,
Philly,
that's
exactly.
True.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because we're going into territories in this rap beef where, like, aside from like people trying to kill each other, like we're going into major ass claims where it's like wife beating allegations and like actual pedophile allegations. And I've said this before that I think there's a compelling case that, like, especially since he's around sex offenders and shit like that in Drake's circle, that like there's a like weird pattern of behavior that obviously you could sell, but if you want to prove it, if you want to like top something like the Heart Part 5 or whatever, like, and run with the pedophile narrative further, you'd want to like kind of get a little bit more deeper into that. And I think Kendrick could do that, but like, yeah, you got to really dig. Like, it looks bad right now if, like, the information fed to you is, like, legitimately fake. And, like, Drake is, like, saying, yeah, like, I fooled you. I tricked you. It just, like, hurts, like, your reputation. Like, it makes you look like a joke a little bit. Like, you got clowned on. You're, like, rapping about a baby girl that doesn't really exist.
Yeah.
Nah, I think Drake's dead.
Okay. All right, we'll keep going. We're on 616 in LA.
Off-white Sunseeker at the marina. Fuck a phantom, I like to buy yachts when I get the fever. Wine cooler, spill on my white t-shirt, the sightseer. Trifecta, money, morals, and culture. That's my leisure, my visa. Passport tatted, I shall hub in Ibiza. Luke Cali's dwellings in Brooklyn just to book me some pizza. Who can reach us? Only God can teleport this type of freedom. God, my confession is yours. But who am I if I don't go to war? There's opportunity when living with loss. I discover myself when I fall short. Raise my hands to a fallen sky. I fantasize, me jumping planets immortalized. I correspond, three angels watching me all the time. Put my children to sleep with a prayer, then close my eyes. Definition of peace, tell me who gon' stop me. I come from love, and still cover my heart, then open me up. Remember when, picked up a pen, lyrics that I can trust. Timid soul, staring in the mirror, asking where I was from often. I know this type of power is gon' cost, but I live in circadian rhythms of a shooting star. The mannerisms of Raphael, I can heal and give you art. But the industry's cooked as I pick the carcass apart. Yeah, somebody's lying, I can see the vibes on act. Even he looking compromised, let's peel the layers back. Ain't no brownie points will beam your chest, harass an ant. Fucking with good people, make good people go to bat. Conspiracies about cash, dog, that's not even the leak. Find the jewels like cash, dog, I just need you to think. Are you finally ready to play? Have you ever, let's see. Have you ever thought that OVO is working for me? Fake bully, I hate bullies, you must be a terrible person. Everyone inside your team is whispering that you deserve it. Can't touch you, slide about it, this one is just gonna resurface. Every dog gotta have his day, now live in your purpose. It was fun until you start to put money in the streets, then lost money cause they came back with no receipts. I'm sorry that I live a boring life, I love peace, but war ready if the world is ready to see you bleed. The Elohim KTW, know you can't sleep, these images trouble you. Know the wires in your circle should puzzle you. If you were street smart, then you would've caught that your entourage is only to hustle you. 100 niggas that you got on salary, and 20 of them want you as a casualty, and one of them is actually next to you, and two of them is practically tired of your lifestyle, just don't got the audacity to tell you. But let me tell you some game, cause I can see you, my little homie. You playing dirty with proper.
See, that doesn't age as well. You're
playing what?
That kind of line doesn't age as well. If he's like bragging about, yeah, I got moles in your like circle, it doesn't age as well. If like the heart, if like he's saying like, yeah, like, no, like, we fucking tricked you. We got fake moles in there pretending to actually, like, be against me, but we fed you fake information. That makes Kendrick look like a goofball.
For not looking into it further?
Yeah, like,
but
not
investing. But it also is just rap.
It's yeah, like, but you have to think about it this way. It's, in a way, it's not just rap. Because everyone's just like, oh, it's not a courtroom, it's just rap. But it's like, well, like in rap, in your rap beefs, you still want credibility. You want respect. And if you're making moves like that, like, and you're getting outplayed by like your competitor, you're getting like tricked, like, then your lines in your songs are not as effective as they once were. Like, if Kendrick had outplayed Drake and he had outsmarted like everyone thought he did, and that's why what had like so much weight to like meet the grams. Like saying like I have moles in your circle, like that was like objectively, if like that was the case, if he had tricked Drake, if he had actually people undercover, like that's effective. Like he outplayed, by that point he would have outplayed him. That's effective. That makes like Drake look bad. So like, yeah, I don't know. People are like, well, it's not that deep. It's not that deep. It's rap. But like, no, it's rap beef. But it's like, dude, it's becoming serious, serious. Like the credibility, the reputations are on the line for both of these people, especially like Drake, if his stuff is proven. Like Kendrick, he can bounce back from like being a wife beater. But like still, like if that shit is like true, it still hurts his reputation enough to where people won't really look at him quite the same after this.
I gotta think about it more. I don't know. I think it's weird. I think because of who these people are, what's gonna happen is nobody's going to give a fuck about the credibility, and they're just going to go, yeah, but this one sounds way better, and it sounds like he's getting his ass beat way harder, and that's going to be the end of it. Or whoa, that was like really, really cool the way that he coded a diss. I feel like that's it for this.
Yeah, but that's
because
like,
it's so
that's
massive.
Like, that to me, that's like that's the boring fucking way of looking at this. Like, yeah, if you want to like listen to a track. I know what you're saying. I'm saying a lot of people are going to do that, but that's the boring dick rider thing to do. Like, if you want like the competitive spirit, if you want to like actually like say like, oh man, like this line hit harder because this shit is actually factual. This shit is actually true. Like, that's what I mean is like looking into this stuff, not only just for like the sake of like getting more into like the understanding the lyrics. Like, you're just, like, actually gonna, like, get an idea of, like, who actually won this rap beef, like, more objectively speaking.
I think...
Like, everyone's the biggest, making the... Yeah, go ahead.
I think the biggest thing, other than like, how hard each song bangs and how, like, intelligently crafted they are...
Yeah.
I think the fact that Kendrick dropped Meet the Grams 30 fucking minutes after Family Matters with a fucking cover... of all the things addressed in Family Matters as a photo, that is going to be the last thing people look at. They're going to go, he was ready and he fucking took a shit down his open neck hole. That's what that's going to be. It's yep. He was watching and he sniped your head off your shoulders. You're beyond dead. You are not only dead, your entire soul was like, annihilated from existence. You aren't even you're not even in limbo. Cease to exist.
You're failing. Everyone here are gonna think. Everyone here is failing to take in consideration what I'm saying, because everyone's saying I'm doing the actually, can you provide a source? But like, no, this is like what makes like the rap beef like more objectively, like whether you can say whether or not
you,
one person should have. No, this
to you. I don't think his audience is going to give a flying fuck. They're not debaters. Not even just for me.
You're objectively speaking, that information, that's the fake mole. That cover art, that is the fake mole. That is the fake mole. Like, that t-shirt on the cover art is actually making fun of Kendrick. It's a shorty t-shirt. And then, like, some of the other stuff is in reference to, like, Rick Ross's pre-diabetes stuff. Like, it's a lot more, like, layered. That's what I'm saying is, like, it's just levels to this. Like, when you, like, look at the information, it's actually different. Like, it's actually not as impactful as you would think. That's the point I'm saying. Like, the fake information about a daughter within the song, now that stuff is, like, discrediting, like, Kendrick a little bit. Especially with, like, the wife beater allegations.
Do you like rap, Emery?
Yes, this is why I'm getting annoyed by everyone talking about this like so like one dimensionally.
Yo,
like,
Philly, set this white boy straight, man.
Oh my god.
I just wanted to get back to listening to music, but Emery, just while you got a second, just go to Drake's latest video and just read the comments. Not that the comments matter, but like if you're trying to gauge how people are judging this battle. Go under Drake's own video and read the comments. All right.
Yeah, that's
look at the likes, look at the dislikes, then go to Kendrick's videos, read the likes.
That's just dick
riders. Okay, so where Drake's dick riders under Kendrick's videos?
I don't know, but like that's the point.
Would you say Drake has more fans than Kendrick? Would you say that Drake has more fans than Kendrick?
I have no idea how you measure that exactly.
You would measure that in album sales. You would measure that in Instagram followings, Twitter followings.
I don't know how you measure that exactly. You can talk about sales all you want, but like, I don't know if you can objectively say one person has more fans other than the other. Like, sales is a whole different thing, especially if you're appealing to two different markets. Like, Kendrick's appealing to conscious viewers who like the conscious raps, and then like Drake is appealing to more like pop mainstream stuff. So like it's two different levels to this. Like
it's gonna be people that listen to Drake in clubs and aren't like actually fans of him. They just like partying to his music, and then Kendrick might have people that are genuine fans.
Yeah, and this is why the last Kendrick diss track to Drake was like more effective than Meet the Grams, because it was much more of a banger actually being played in clubs. Like, people were actually, like, playing that shit in L.A. or they were playing that shit. Mustard was playing that shit, and people were bopping to it. And it was much more effective.
You were just talking about like how battles are won and what people think and what people are going to remember and like what the public is like, how they're going to judge this. And if Kendrick, you know, if that's going to take away from his credibility. And I was just saying, you know, while we listen to the rest of these songs, you just go check out some of the comments under each person's video to kind of gauge like what the fans of each particular, because this is like a battle of the fans.
All the fans aren't talking about it exactly the same as like people who are actually looking into it. It's like if you just like kind of like casually listen to this, like
I'm not saying this is an objective truth of the matter. I'm just saying you were just talking about people's reaction to this and people's feelings on this and like what the crowd, like what the masses are going to think. And there's not any way to know this other than look at comments, look at the way people are reacting to it. And I'm just telling you to go do that before you start saying like, oh, Kendrick has no credibility now.
You're presenting this as if it's new information, but I've already seen like all the like comments under where it's like, oh, Drake's coping. Oh, this is
Can you then come in here and say that Kendrick now has no credibility and nobody's going to believe him?
It's not that he has no credibility. I'm saying if you look into it, actually look, you're going to have an idea of like, oh, wow, this actually kind of hurts like some of these like points being made a little bit more. If you're working off literally fake information, the Secret Daughter shit, fake, never proven. And if it gets proven,
Drake said that in the song. We know, bro. Everybody knows. Drake told everybody.
You guys are missing
the point. It doesn't matter. I get what you're saying.
I'm so sorry. You can't be objective. You're slobbering Kendrick's dick so much.
Who said anything about being objective? Hey, Emery, I'm telling you.
Because we haven't finished the videos and you have. I'm
talking to people in mid-dick suck section. Like, come on.
I didn't say anything about being
objective. Slobbering the cock. It's absolutely insane. True. I feel like I'm not even
so quick to hop in here and defend Drake. We didn't even finish listening to the damn song.
First of all, I'm not defending Drake. First of all,
Poison the well.
I'm not defending Drake. I think he's likely a fucking groomer. In fact, out of this whole beef, I kind of wanted the information to be out there in the public, and I wanted proof for that information. Kind of why I'm being so critical of Kendrick in the first place. I want fucking proof. I don't want him being tricked by fucking Drake about a secret daughter like a dumb fuck. Like, he looks stupid right now. So
Drake looks stupid. You're wrong. Drake looks stupid. That's the point. You're wrong. Nobody thinks Kendrick looks stupid because Drake planted some fake fucking story. Like, bro, that's so easy to do. It's so easy to do, bro. And it's so like lame and it's corny and it's a self-owned.
You should expect Kendrick to do more research and to actually.
What research is going to do? Supposedly, if he was hiding this daughter, how much research is there to do?
A lot.
I think it's fair to say that Kendrick's probably in more similar circles with Drake and probably has more insight into it.
He was fed bad intel. Okay, I mean, is that a own on somebody?
Yes,
like, if he was a news media outlet, I would say that's fucking horrible to do. But he's a rapper, bro.
His
research
right
is a
now.
Fucking
How do you not understand that makes him look really fucking bad, especially since Drake's
it's
information.
Not that I don't understand how it makes him look bad. I don't agree that it does make him look bad. What part don't you understand? Okay, I didn't say
Tell me how working with fake information in a diss track, and then the next diss track reveals, hey, you dumb fuck, that information is not real. We fucking fooled you. We fooled you. How does that not make
because
him look
who puts
bad?
Out a fake who puts out fake propaganda on
it's
having
rapping,
a fake daughter?
No rules. Of course they're gonna do that. What are you talking about?
Oh, now there's no rules. Are there rules for Kendrick and not for Drake?
No, there's no rules, period.
So if the gloves are off, then what are you here whining about?
I'm not whining about anything. I'm telling you objectively.
You're like,
we
actually don't have proof that Drake has a daughter. So actually he loses and Kendrick doesn't have any credibility at all, actually. No, that is what you're doing.
I said he looks
you are defending Drake.
Previously did before.
Okay.
He's not,
to you.
Can he
to
wait?
You
has he addressed the wife beater allegations? By the way, I don't hear people on that.
Why would you address something that's not true?
Well, why would you not?
Because it's not true.
It's if it's not true.
And,
it's
and Kendrick it's is either, and what you do in a rap right? battle is you go on the offensive. You don't go on the defensive and say, "Oh, well, actually, you lied about this, and I can prove that you lied about that." No, you go on the offensive. We talked about this yesterday, bro. It's not how you win a rap battle, dog.
That's actually
you go on the offensive.
Actually,
okay. Take go.
You actually can go on the defense. And make spin it up on them. Yes, that's happened numerous times, even in this conflict. I don't know what you're talking about. So, yes, you can do that.
Yes, in a line or two, you can, like, play defense, but you don't make a whole song.
And he hasn't even given
just
a line.
Saying, oh, well, actually, bro, you don't have any proof for that. And, actually, bro, I actually set that up the whole time, you dummy. And, actually, you're, like, deeply troubled for being molested by your cousin when you were five. Actually... And like, it was just so weak. It's just
wait,
weak.
Wait, why are you
bro,
crying now? Wait, is that too far for you now?
Did I say it was too far? I said it was weak.
You brought it up like
follow,
it was
follow me. Follow me. I said it was
I
weak.
I agree with you, actually. That is too weak.
Okay,
that was
so
a weak
I didn't say it was too far. Only, so don't put words in my mouth.
It was a weak jab, objectively speaking, because that's not even what the song's about. So I agree with you.
Yes.
All right.
So you should also agree that Drake has lost and he's done.
No, actually, like it's pretty fucking close. You need receipts at this point to like make any of these.
What metric are you judging that it's close?
You need receipts to back up each claim.
By which metric are you judging that this is close?
By which metric are you judging? Just YouTube comments?
By well, there are plenty of ways to judge. You can go by polls. You can go by likes to dislikes on their videos. You can go by the numbers of streams each person has. Yes, there are plenty of ways to look at who won this. What? It's always been a numbers thing. You're trying to win the fans over.
Really? It's a numbers game.
Bro. You're trying to win the fans over.
If Drake come out with a track and it's all lies and all of it's disproven, but it's still liked by the popularity... Like, would you say objectively he won based on facts?
If Drake came out with
things... Was it objectively the stronger diss track?
Well, I'm not saying Kendrick's diss tracks were stronger because of his lies. I'm saying that his credibility is not taken away because of those things. Yes, if Drake made a whole diss track full of lies with no truth in it, it was just 100% fact. Fabricated.
And the popularity
one thing,
still liked it.
One
still
thing
it
out of everything. Are you missing that he made four diss tracks? Said maybe 10 to 12 different things about Drake, and you're saying this one thing was proven this wrong. So therefore, everything he's saying is discredited, and we might as well just throw all these tracks out.
I didn't say
okay,
that.
Okay, so why are you comparing it to a track where Drake comes out with all lies? You said, what if Drake came out?
I'm saying. Hey, can I speak my thing, or are you just going to talk over me? I can. All right, cool.
I love when people do this part. This is like the funnest part of the conversation. Just go, bro. Go.
This ain't serious to me, so it's fun. No, I'm saying objectively speaking, that one crucial piece of evidence, this was supposed to be Kendrick's a story of Adonis moment of revealing not only just another child, but potentially more children in that baby girl line, in the baby girl verse. So if that information is objectively false, can't be proven, and it was false information, like put in there purposely to fuck with Kendrick's credibility, to purposely fuck with Kendrick, then yeah, that makes him look like a goofball who doesn't do his research, who doesn't do his diving into information to make a proper diss track. Like, he's just rushing. Yeah, it makes him really look bad. Yeah, like he's not dotting all his I's and crossing his T's like Kendrick should be.
Okay, and I don't blame you for having that opinion. From my point of view.
That's what I'm saying, objectively speaking. I'm saying you need receipts to back up these things to make this stuff stronger objectively. Because otherwise, it is just Kendrick stan or Drake stans dick-sucking their favorite artists. You have to be more objective speaking-wise.
Okay. So
that's what I'm saying. Sorry, go ahead.
I got you. No, and I don't... Like, I disagree that to win a rap battle... You have to be like, 100% truthful, because that rarely ever happens. None of rap is 100% truthful. So to put those expectations on a rap battle, I think is a little bit unfair. Okay, but I do get what you're saying, that this does take away Kendrick Lamar, some of Kendrick's credibility, that he was so quick to jump the gun that he didn't do his due diligence to find out. Okay, I fully understand. My point of view is that is not Kendrick's point. If his whole point was, Drake, you're a piece of shit because you're hiding your daughter, I would get it. But that was just one on a list of 8 or 9 things that he brought up that he had a problem with Drake for. He said it in the first diss track, that this not just is me, the whole culture feels this way, right? And if you look at any hip hop commentary, they will tell you that Drake has not been very well liked or embraced within the hip hop community for years. He's never won any Grammys. He's never on anybody's list of best rappers. You know, the only accolades he's going to get is the money he makes and the fans he has. Kendrick's whole thing with him is, you have a sussy history with the way that you treat women, with the way that you're enamored with young women, especially people. Well, he didn't bring up Millie Bobby Brown, but Drake must have a fucking guilty conscience, because Drake brought up Millie Bobby Brown. But that is one of the people that people have looked at Drake sideways over the years as to his relationships with certain teenagers, right? And she's not the only one. There's a long list of them.
Here's an important question. If the culture wasn't filling him for so long, why the fuck were they working with him for so long?
To make
long?
Money?
Why has he been money. In the game?
But Kendrick for wasn't. But Kendrick
no, no,
wasn't.
No, 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 no,
but
no, no,
Kendrick
no,
wasn't. And no, this is between culture, him and Kendrick.
If the culture wasn't filling him for so long, why has he been so strong in the game for like nearly 18 fucking years? I don't know. Maybe I'm exaggerating. I don't know the exact amount. But
listen, after
long,
this, people will still fuck with him. After all this comes out, people will still fuck with him. Right,
I know, that's what I'm saying.
I don't think that really this is really anything on Kendrick's argument.
If this is really true, he wouldn't be in this culture as long as he has been. This is the closest he's been to actually been like actually hated at like its worst. He's always kind of had like people have always had like a lingering hate for him. There's always been those people.
How much hip hop content do you consume, Emery? I'm curious, because this is just confusing me what you're saying. How much hip-hop content besides DJ Academics do you consume?
I've been a fan of hip-hop for, like, quite a long time.
So which podcast do you watch?
I'm
just curious to know where you get your information from.
Recently, I've just been watching Joe Budden mostly.
Okay, Joe Budden. All right, I mean, I'm not trying to put you on the spot and say, like, well, do you really know hip-hop? But I'm just curious as to what hip-hop you've been consuming to where you would get the idea that Drake has been accepted within the culture, right? Doing features with people
I won't say just widely loved and appreciated, and there's no criticisms of Drake, and there's no hatred at all. I think every rapper gets that. And especially if you're number one, you're going to get a lot of that. What I'm saying is that, like, no rapper can last this fucking long if objectively speaking, the culture wasn't filling him to some degree. Like, that's just impossible. You can't do that.
Okay.
Like, it's just not.
No. I will concede.
It's not even remotely feasible. Like, you just have to be.
I will concede. Drake does make good music. Okay.
Yeah.
And people do appreciate his music, but I don't think people like anything else about him. Kendrick Lamar said, money, power, respect. I think the third one is better. And he's alluding to the fact that Drake has no respect within the industry. He has none. He has no credibility, respect. People do things because either they fear his power, or he makes them do it, or he manipulates them in some way. He's talked about Drake's him lying, his fake image, his fake accents, his usage of people in Atlanta to
keep his career relevant.
It's a lot of different things that Kendrick is coming at him. Also, he works with a pedophile. His right hand man is
Kendrick works with sex offender. I don't want to hear you say that.
Okay, he worked with him. No, he did a track with him. He did a song with him. He did a song with him. Okay, wait, Emery, is there a difference between doing a song with somebody and employing somebody? Is there a difference between doing a song with somebody and employing somebody?
It depends.
It doesn't matter. Either way, you're supporting that person.
Hold on. it depends. Money. It depends who paid for the feature.
I don't. Okay. It doesn't really matter. Really? Nate, you're lending credibility. You're lending credibility, and like you're basically like saying like this guy's good in my opinion. Like I fuck with this guy. Like for the most part. Like when you're working with someone like that closely. So, okay. And also,
okay.
I don't hear Kendrick, and I don't hear Future, and I don't hear so many other rappers in this industry. In fact, it's kind of weird. I don't hear any of them talking about how Ye's been like doing some Nazi saluting and shit like that. So, like this industry to me, fuck. If like that's what respect is, like. I don't really care.
I'm
like,
sorry. Is Kendrick Lamar battling Kodak Black? Is he battling Kanye West, or is he battling Drake? I'm sorry, I got lost here for a second.
My point is that he's a hypocrite. So like this takes away the sting a little.
So you're guilty by association.
Like, again, I argued with you about this before. Like the morality, the virtue signaling of like, oh, like this, what the culture? You got you're around pedophiles. It's like, bro, you work with like you've worked with sex offenders. You worked with wife beaters. This doesn't have the sting that you think it does. If anyone's actually objectively looking at this, yeah, no, it doesn't really have the sting. Like, it's a good diss track, has good disses, and most of them are probably objectively true. Even the groomer stuff, like you can't prove that yet, but like it's probably fucking true with the pattern. But it doesn't have quite the sting when you're a hypocrite. Like, it just doesn't. Especially if you're a wife beater. Sorry. Like, it just doesn't.
Trib, you mean that Hotep shit?
Okay.
Sorry, that's what I mean. That's all I mean. Philly. Is that I want receipts. I would love to see proof on either side.
Two things. Yeah. Two things for both of you. Philly, I got a quick question. Do you know if Kendrick is like a... What is it? A black Israelite? Is like that type of.
Is he a black Israelite?
Yeah, like Nick Cannon, like that type of.
He's literally had a lyric. I don't know if he would call himself a black Israelite exactly. I don't know that, but there's a lyric that he said where he said, "I'm an Israelite. Don't call me black no more." Like that's, I think, one of his songs. I have to look up exactly which song, but like that's one of his lyrics.
Oh. Isn't
besides that one lyric, I haven't heard him talk much about like black Israelites. But if he says I'm an Israelite and I'm not black no more, I think he's obviously separating himself from the black Israelites.
Yeah.
Okay. Also,
those are two distinctive things.
He's not like Jay Electronica, where he's like I'm an Israelite, black Israelite, and like he's not doing some anti-Semitic shit from what I've seen.
Okay. Also, to go with the objectivity point, Philly, click into the screen share for a sec.
Okay, let me get there. I'm sorry.
You're gonna know what this is as soon as you see it.
All right. All right, I'm here.
All right. This shit went kind of hard.
I got motion sickness.
With the this ain't no fucking objectivity of it.
I'm gonna expose your business and make it well known how you snitched on your co-defendants. The fake ain't rocking anymore. I'm getting so explicit. Karma knocking at your door like Jehovah's Witness. I'm not saying it's the truth. I know you did it. Would you like to see the proof? I could go and get it.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh man!
All that dick eating shit y'all be doing every fucking battle.
He pulled out the whole fucking
that's statement. What I mean. Is if you?
Oh no! Oh no!
He pulled out the whole statement.
If you do shit like this in a real rap,
he just ended this man's career. Yeah, this is what he's saying. It is.
Yeah, dude.
Wait.
Like that's what makes him.
No, I don't know. I'm just fucking kidding.
Okay, I was just saying.
That's what I'm saying. If that's what makes it so much more impactful to me. A diss track can be really, really good, but like when I'm going back and forth, I'm listening to both tracks. I'm thinking to myself, okay, but like, what's really true? Like for sure, true that like makes this line hit even more. Yeah, that's why I said it's hard to really call. You know, I can't say objectively speaking like one person won over the other.
So the reason I think that Kendrick won is because he was, like I said to you yesterday, breaking down Drake's character and like literally pointing out the reasons why he is poison to hip hop. and not only hip hop, everybody around him in his life, even his children, right? Like even down to his children, the his behavior, his character as a man has those type of effects on the people around him. Is it the truth or not? I don't know. Drake can have a great relationship with his son.
Sure.
But Drake, Kendrick, the way he puts it, you know, it's breaking down his character. And I think that that is part of the allure of people, and part of the people why so many people are behind Kendrick is because they've been feeling this way about Drake. But Kendrick puts it in a way that, first of all, is, you know, he's like the best rapper right now. So the way he puts it into words, people are just going to gravitate towards that. And Drake, on the other hand, is coming out defensive, like liar, liar, pants on fire, like type this, and that just.
But you're literally not mentioning the fact that that is what Drake was doing as well, going after Kendrick's character. He said, "You're beating your wife. You proposed her in 2015. Still, never married her. And in this most recent
fact, his character. That's not an indictment on his character.
What are you talking about? What do you mean?" That's all
you propose
about
to your girlfriend, your high school sweetheart that you've been with since you were 18, but you guys didn't get married yet.
Your high school sweetheart, you've been beating her, and she's
what if they've been having relationship troubles?
6 months. He's been in.
What if they've been having relationship troubles?
Not actually with his wife, not actually with his kid. And if
wait, is separating from your girlfriend an indictment on your character?
If you've been having emotional abuse, beating her, and she's going to your manager.
But he's talked about his emotional distance.
Your manager's
he's
kid,
talked
yes,
about his emotional distance from his wife, though. Dude, he doesn't hide or shy from any of this.
Okay, you just
Kendrick will indict his own character, bro.
You just confirmed it for me.
No, Kendrick confirmed it on his last CD.
Okay, I get
Kendrick,
it. I get it.
Everything
I get
Drake
it.
Is saying, Kendrick already says.
I don't. I'm not speaking to somebody who actually cares about.
What makes you say that?
Are any of the objective?
Oh, is there a fact I'm not acknowledging?
Yes, you
which
are.
One?
You are defending you.
Wait,
defending.
Which fact did I not acknowledge?
You said that's not character flaws. In any other rap beef, if it wasn't.
No, I said it's having. This is, no, I didn't say that's not. I asked you a question that you never answered. I said is being in a relationship and having a rocky relationship and or separating from your partner a character flaw is what
if
I asked you, and you never answered that. You just kept ranting.
I just told you, if you are exposed, you are taking away the context of him being revealed as beating her, leading her on, proposing 2015, never getting married for like 9 years, and now they're separated. It's been 6 months, and he's been in New York City while she's been fucking it. I just still in L.A., I think. I don't know where her location is, but the point is they're separated. She's not following him on IG, but she is following the manager still, Dave Free, who apparently is actually the parent of one of Kendrick's kids. So that's some character.
So tell me this. Emery, I hear you. Like, trust me, I listen to everything. Like, I know you're laying out your argument, but you're not revealing anything to me. I understand everything.
No,
you're
oh my gosh. Okay,
when
you're just dick sucking.
That also wasn't a character flaw.
You're just dick sucking.
Talk to me for a second, Emery. Talk to me for a second.
You're not objectively going through this,
Emery.
Okay. I understand. I get it. No,
I'm patiently waiting
to do this.
I've laid this out for you guys three separate different times. If you don't understand how that's character flaws, if you don't understand that, I can't
it's
get through.
It's not a character flaw. It's a situation flaw.
So far, you are gobbling up the cum of Kendrick. It's okay. I get it.
Wait. Emery, can you shut the fuck up and use your ears instead of your vocal cords for a second, dude? It's not a
character flaw. You don't know the character of the other person in that relationship. It's a situation flaw. I get it. You don't know what character flaws are. I get it.
Calm down. All right. Emery, got you.
No, you're just objectively wrong.
Calm down. All right, chill. Bro, I literally listened to everything you said. Can you just shut the fuck up for a second?
You haven't listened to me at all. You've actually.
Too busy. He beat his wife.
I get it.
Fuck you.
He beat his wife. He fucking married. He didn't marry her yet. He left. He moved out. That is a character flaw. I heard you.
Okay,
will you fucking listen for a second?
Then stop.
Just because I don't agree doesn't mean I don't hear you. We just have a simple disagreement that we need to talk about here. If it's all right with you.
Okay.
If you just want to hear yourself talk, I'll just listen. You can just talk all you want. Well, if you want to have like a conversation, we can have a conversation.
It feels like I have to talk more because no one's actually listening to me.
Wait,
Emery,
hold on.
Dude, you said...
Go ahead, everyone's hearing you. You're not listening to anyone else. You don't know his opinion.
No, you haven't heard it yet. To me. No.
You haven't shut the fuck up.
Are you trolling right
now,
bro?
That's what we've been listening to.
Okay.
I think he's trolling.
Bro, all right. Lay out your dumb fuck argument. I'll listen. Lay out your dumb fuck argument.
What the fuck? Wait. All right. Emery. All right. Listen.
Fine.
For one second.
Go ahead.
Okay. You claim that Kendrick Lamar has character flaws and that they were laid out by Drake. And the evidence of that was that he beat his girlfriend, right? He had relationships troubles. He never married her. He moved out. These are all showing massive character flaws of Kendrick Lamar's, right? And then I responded to you by saying that if you would have listened to Mr. Morale, his last CD, you would have known everything that Drake said. Kendrick has talked about his isolation of his wife.
Wrong.
What do you mean?
Wrong. Mr. Morale, if you had actually listened to Mr. Morale,
Why do you keep saying that? If I had actually listened to it,
I just know you're objectively wrong. He was alluding to alcohol problems, but he never alluded to actually beating. He never said, "I've beaten my wife. I've gotten over that hump. My wife had a kid with my manager, and I'm raising the kid. I'm stepping up and being a dad." He's never said any of that. So, wrong again.
What was that song he was talking about? Standing in the kitchen with his wife, with his alcohol addiction, and standing there drunk and lying to his wife about cheating on her, and her with tears in her eyes.
He can see
the isolation in her eyes. What song was that Kendrick was talking about that I didn't listen to?
Wait, no.
That wasn't your claim. Your claim was that he never said that.
I said specifically, the new information revealed is beating her.
Okay.
Hiding the fact with a crisis management team that you beat
hiding the fact with the crisis management team.
The cheating thing is already known. Kendrick's been out about that. He's out about his alcohol problem. He was not out about beating her. And
so what's the story with him beating her? What event are we speaking of here? When did this happen? What year?
What do you mean?
What year did this crisis management thing happen?
This happened way back, like 2015, I believe.
2015, he hired a crisis team because he was accused of beating his wife. Is what you're now claiming?
Yeah. If we're taking everything Kendrick says as fact, if we're pretending that's facts, then we can pretend everything Drake says is facts. If we're not getting the proof,
I'm gonna say this to you one more time. Hopefully, you listen to me. Kendrick is attacking Drake's character, his character as a man, the way he moves, like the way nobody respects him. He doesn't have a good word. He's a liar. He uses people. He's a snake. He fucking has ghostwriters. He's everything about him is fake. He has a crafted image.
I get it.
Canadian. What other flaws do we have here?
I get it.
Did I mention he's Canadian? That's another like big thing here. Big character flaw we're missing here.
That's actually huge.
Yeah, people are missing the fact that he's Canadian.
I know who I'm dealing with.
That is a humongous character flaw.
I get it. No one's actually objectively speaking about any of this. Okay, cool. I get it.
Hey, Emery.
Emery, I love you. Can we just listen to the songs, bro?
Emery.
No, you're just wrong. You're just wrong. You said he's attacking his character. I already agreed
he
with
him. He is. Listen to what he's saying in these songs.
I already agree. I don't know how many
times. Take out the fucking daughter. Take that part out. Erase that. Listen to everything else he's saying. Jesus Christ.
By point basis, it doesn't matter. He's discredited. If that information.
What's Drake's other points besides him beating his wife? What other points did he make against Kendrick that are valid in your eyes?
Yeah, they free his manager. Like having
that's a point against Kendrick.
That actually be that
his wife
actually,
cheating on him is a point against Kendrick.
Yes, yeah, actually,
how?
Like it's pretty emasculating.
Wait, him raising another man's daughter is a point. I mean, another man's kid is a point against him.
Hold on. Both of you.
Him raising another man's kid is a point against him.
Yes.
Wow.
If you're being cut,
I've never heard that one before.
Hold on.
I'm sorry, Kendrick.
It's all good.
aren't like, okay, aren't people like people that are invested in rap, like the black community, a little bit more on wait, the conservative think,
wait,
side?
Wait. Okay. Are you like speaking of just the black community or
in people rap in the black community?
In the black community. Okay, yes. Gotcha.
Aren't they a little bit more on the conservative side in regards to that type of shit? Where they would Kendrick think that that makes you less of a man to be cheated on by
Kendrick,
your wife?
Yeah, exactly. Kendrick is not Destiny. He wouldn't get away with being cussed.
I don't think they're as progressive as you are.
I don't see anybody shitting on him for that. I don't see anybody making fun of him for that. Is that because they're Kendrick stans or what?
Yes. That's my whole point. No one's looking at this objectively speaking. Like Drake stands
on.
Drake stands
on.
Kendrick stands on.
Like people will lay this out on Twitter to you that this is not a big deal.
I'm not a fan of either of them.
Well, he's asking me how black people would view this.
If all this information is true, as people, I'm not a fan of either. Like I like their music, but I'm saying like,
why not Kendrick?
If you get revealed to be cucked by your manager after...
By a pedophile liar?
Yeah, that's even more embarrassing. Like, say, like, Drake is... Yeah, which
no,
I think he is.
Even
say,
more reason like, to not believe
yeah,
it.
If all this information is revealed by a pedophile, especially a groomer, that's fucking funny to me, dude. It's like getting your information revealed by food shops.
What?
Like, bro, you just... Like, that's the biggest hell you can take.
I think I would be fine if whatever food shop said about me, because that would have been
not if that information is true. Not if that information is true, STV.
I would actually want food shop. If there was any dirt on me, I would want food shop to be the one to reveal it. Trust me.
STV, if food shops somehow got info,
who would you want to reveal it? Destiny or food shops? Tell me.
Well, I'd prefer Destiny.
Who would you want to reveal the information? Destiny or food shops? If somebody found out like you were secretly I don't know, like the worst thing that you can imagine that would embarrass you, who would you want to reveal that? Food shops, obviously, because you can discredit her so easily. Like, come on, this is so simple. Why are you making this so fucking complicated?
Well, not if the information's objectively true.
Yes, if the information was true, you would want food shops to reveal that. Not Destiny.
As bad as beating your wife, and it was objectively
you would rather
true.
Food
and the evidence.
It,
no, I'm
Destiny.
Saying what I'm saying is it's more embarrassing. Yes.
Emery, why has this got you so emotional, dude?
Because everyone's like dick sucking, like either Drake or they're dick sucking Kendrick. And when I come in here and I argue,
won,
when I come
bro.
In, hold on.
He's got to be a winner and a loser. Why does it got to be dick sucking? Like, there's a winner, there's a loser. People think Drake lost. Sorry.
I'm the only one actually being objective. I literally said,
you're the only one.
You're not being
literally
objective.
Literally the
bro.
Only one. Jesus Christ. Literally the only one.
I'm trying to figure out how many Drake posters you got on your wall at this stage.
I have like zero. I can show you my wall if you want.
Dude,
I can tell you what's
just
on my
saying, like how hard you going like you
I don't
feel like you can
bear
him to...
don't pull the whole you're Drake dick riding right now. I'm telling
you are,
objectively,
you are.
I'm telling
no,
you objectively
are.
Speaking right now
speaking,
it's a close like, yeah
okay so objectively speaking what
is,
do we have
what you're saying what you're saying right now is what a Kendrick dick rider would say.
Motherfucker, can you listen to my opinion?
No,
you have
no,
to
I can't actually
sentence.
Because you're too busy
to anyone talking
to you. Can actually Jesus hear your opinion. Like it sounds
yeah,
like
you can't.
My crab said like five sentences. Just let him cook for
motherfucker,
a little bit.
You can't get someone's opinion if you don't let him say it.
Go ahead.
Okay, I can cook. Okay, sweet. What objectively do what do we have factual, like verifiable, on either side of the battle that we know for sure?
I mean, we already, like, that's the other thing.
This is wild.
This shouldn't be a hard answer.
This
you
is
say
wild?
You know all the shit about it. And just what do we have objectively verifiable fact?
I think verifiable
that
fact.
That have been brought up in
the
song.
Verifiable
sure.
doesn't start with I think.
But.
I already told you, I think there's no verifiable facts.
Okay,
sure
so if there's no verifiable facts.
In terms of big information that actually matters, like new information, no.
Okay, no, so no. If there's no verifiable facts.
We already knew the culture vulture shit. Like, that's been like.
Motherfucker. Emery.
We've
dude,
already been knew that, and that's not new
to
information.
Be nice to you right now,
no
but
cares.
You're making me want to not. If there's no facts and it's all just shit slinging, whoever's got the better bars wins. And it's just that simple.
That's also subjective.
I would willing to bet you do not listen to a ton of rap, right? And even you fucking realize this. Come on, how hard is this to understand? Or like, even this is like intuitive. Bro,
I question if you've listened to a ton of rap at this point. Because
you've been in Twitch polls for the last however long. You know these debates, facts don't fucking matter. It's about how you look, how you come off, your fucking rhetoric, bro. Come on,
different variations of rap. I'm probably more open to any.
Emery, Tom McDonald doesn't count, dude.
I don't like Tom McDonald at all. Dave W. He's fucking trash.
Who's your favorite rapper?
Fucking Jay-Z, I would say.
So when he said he turned 900,
I think Jay-Z has probably been the like most consistent in terms of like.
So when he says he's a big time drug dealer and a mobster, and that's proven to be a whole fucking fabrication and a lie, why does that not change anything? Is because you're a Jay-Z dick sucker, or is it because you like his music? Because you know he wasn't some big fucking coke boss who sold $900,000 worth of dope, and that's how he started his record industry. You know that's a fucking lie, right? A big lie that Jay-Z told his whole career.
Hold on, two things. First of all, Jay-Z objectively lost to Nas. Even as my favorite rapper, I can say that, like, I can say objectively he lost. The other thing is, I can also be critical of, like, Jay-Z as a person, too. Like, I don't think he's a very good person.
Okay.
So...
What about Nas? Do you think he's a good person?
I don't know Nas very well enough to say definitively yes or no. I haven't really got the hint that he's a bad person, but I wouldn't be surprised if he's a bad person. I don't know. I don't trust any of these industry people.
Jay-Z says he's a bad person.
I don't go off just based off the word of a rapper.
Okay. So why are we going with Kendrick's a wife beater again?
This is why I said the receipts. You need receipts.
All right. So what receipts did I bring
this
up?
Wait. I've said this since the very beginning. I said, you need receipts. That's why I cannot say objectively whether one won or not. You haven't been listening.
So you came in this whole time just to say neither guy has receipts. I don't know who won. That was your whole point of coming in here?
I said...
A round of applause.
I said from the very beginning, I don't know. Like all this information out there, I need some receipts to really like get a clear indication of who won. Because if any of these things are factual, that makes the lines hit harder. And in the long run, when people are actually talking about like this, like the Tupac and Biggie situation or Jay-Z and Nas, you can actually speak about it more accurately in a more accurate way of who won.
I don't think that's why you came in here. You came in here to say like, oh, if this stuff isn't real, Kendrick.
Yeah,
you said a whole lot of shit. Played
him. He set him up. He's a fool. He looks like a fool now. He looks like an idiot now.
I'm sorry it hurts your feelings, but that would be foolish to be fooled by a pedophile. Yes.
Yeah, but that's also something that's not verifiable, objective. You just like.
I know. That's why I literally said you need receipts. And you need all that. That's why I said I need.
Why didn't you come in and say Drake didn't provide one receipt for Kendrick beating his wife? Fuck Drake. He's such a slimy. Why didn't you come in and say that? No, you came in and said Kendrick didn't provide. Da, da. Like, come on. We
Well, I said it. I said it. Here's the real reason I said it is because in this room and in a lot of other rooms, I've seen just a lot of dick riding for Kendrick. No one's really been able to.
We was just listening to the songs. No, you hopped in. Nobody was even saying anything.
If Drake had been the one people were dick riding, I would have came in here and been like, well, I still need receipts. And then everyone would have been like,
nobody was dick riding anybody. Kinklemore was sitting there watching the songs.
Philly came in here after you, dude. Philly came in after you, so you can't say Philly was dick riding either.
Oh, you mean chat? You came here to respond to chat?
I talked to Philly about this before and he was dick riding.
Okay. I was saying the same shit right now. How is it dick riding? I'm just saying, like, if you take away all the fucking smears and the lies or whatever, I still think that Kendrick has more of a leg to stand on here. I mean, if that's dick riding, then I guess so. That's just what I think, bro. And I was asking you, what do you think are some good points that Drake brought up? And you had not one.
I already told you the wife beating thing is really
no. Besides that, besides the lie whatever you're saying that we can't prove.
Fuck, bro. Wife beating's another point for Kendrick.
Oh my god. Right, <please.
laughs> Fucking base See, Kendrick.
That's the way you should approach it. Just say I don't just be honest. Just say I don't care.
Well, what if he didn't? I don't care. Why does he need to be honest? What if he didn't?
If you actually, if Emery, you actually,
did you ever consider that he didn't?
If you just want to be honest, just say, hey, I don't care. He okay, moved on. Emery, he doesn't do that
answer
anymore.
Answer my question. What if he Wait, didn't? What? What if he didn't beat his wife? What should he do?
That's what I've been telling you. That's why I need receipts. Because then Drake looks really bad and he objectively lost in every conceivable way. Because that's the biggest piece of ammunition he had against Kendrick. And then objectively right, Emery, speaking, he Emery. Got fucking No. He
I don't
got
want to
slaughtered
circle the drain
if that's not real.
Again. Okay, I don't want to circle the drain again. So I'm just gonna okay. ask you one more time. Besides the unprovable lies, right? Besides the wife beating and besides the daughter, right? What
Wait, has anyone objectively proven the Drake pedophile had? Stuff too, by the way? Like
Yes, Drake's work, he's hired
like, we can't just
a
we...
sex trafficker dude. Who like yeah. got in trouble
well,
with minors?
Again,
so.
I have to reiterate: the industry is full of those people, and Kendrick has worked with plenty of those
hey,
people.
That's not what you asked. That's not what you asked. That's not what you asked.
This doesn't hold the weight.
You asked a question, I answered it, and then you
this doesn't,
fucking
this
pivot
doesn't,
to some other shit.
This doesn't hold the weight that you think it does. The sex offender angle doesn't hold the weight you think it does.
Listen, if Kendrick was battling Jeffrey Epstein, could he not say that? Because you know that there's other billionaires who do sex trafficking. Is that your argument right now?
No, you can say it, but you would be a hypocrite.
Oh boy!
Like if you're okay. if you're protecting so, if you're working with other sex offenders because you ain't got no.
How many pictures are there of Drake then, grinding then on a 17-year-old and grabbing your breast? How many videos are there of Drake grinding on a 17-year-old and grabbing her breast after she told him that she was 17? How many videos of Kendrick are there doing that? I
didn't say Kendrick did that, by the way. Like,
okay. Well, Drake did.
When did I say that?
How many 13-year-olds did Kendrick become best friends with, or however old Millie Bobby Brown was at the time?
I already told you, I agree with that.
How many pictures are there of Kendrick with fucking teenagers in clubs, fucking all hugging and shit and sitting on his lap? How many of those are there?
I said already that I
So you're asking, what proof is there that Drake is a creep? What proof is there that he's a pedo? And I'm telling you.
You actually still need more substance.
Kendrick is going off of.
You actually still need more substance than that. Because if we can go up to food shops.
So he's like,
wait. No.
Who goes up to food shops? Says anything, not me.
If food shop says something along the lines of, well, I masturbate the loli icon, lolicon, and some people can still say, oh, well, I don't know if that makes her a pedophile officially, but yeah, I definitely am not hanging out with that person, then fuck. Like, if Drake makes like a mistake with a 17-year-old or some shit, yeah, like, I guess you could technically say.
A mistake? Did you see the video?
Yeah, pretty large fucking mistake, by the way.
That was not a mistake, bro. That's a character flaw.
That's the other thing. Hold on.
There's no other way to fucking convey to convey this to you. The dude's a creep fucking weirdo who likes young girls, bro. And hires fucking pedophiles, bro. I don't know why you're defending this or you're saying you need proof of this.
You are still
That is the point. That is the whole point.
You are still missing the point. If Kendrick is calling Drake a pedophile and that he works with sex offenders, then why is Kendrick working with sex offenders on his last album? Why is he still not revealing more sex offenders and more and more and more? Why is he not? There's a lot of
why he's working with Kodak Black. I don't know, but he's not fucking battling Kodak Black, bro.
Yeah, I'm curious. Why did he work with him then? Can you explain that to me? Can you defend him on that?
Probably because Kodak. I really don't have no idea. I have no idea if they, what relationship they have.
Why did he work
I don't
with
know.
Emery,
do you really, think working with sex offenders is worse than being a sex offender? Do you really think that?
This is a really dumb point, and I'm going to tell you why in a second.
Okay.
The first thing is... Yeah, if you are a sex offender, if you are a pedophile and you're working with sex offenders, like clearly, like that's really fucking bad and like objectively wrong. But like if you're working with sex offenders in general, that to me, that still speaks really fucking ill of your character and that you're like actually just a piece of fucking
Are you sure of that?
And honestly,
are you sure of that? You're a piece of shit if you work with a sex offender? So what, should sex offenders be relegated to the fucking obscurity for the rest of their life if they make a mistake once?
Yes, actually.
So if you make a mistake once when you're 18, 19, 20, you should never be worked with again? Is that what you're saying? Or anybody who does hire you or works with you should be condemned?
Objectively speaking, yes. If you're making collab albums and you're boosting up their credibility.
Who do you make a collab album with? I'm sorry.
Are not collab albums, collab songs or whatever. Yeah, like if you're boosting their credibility, and there's actually no significant change in Kodak Black's character to actually even provide evidence that he's actually genuinely changed.
How do you know?
How do I know? You're dick sucking so bad. Like you just can't admit.
By asking you, how do you know something?
It's like working with a sex offender is wrong.
It is,
and it probably but speaks to
his. It's not an indictment on his character.
It actually does.
It doesn't make him a hypocrite.
If you're a wife beater who works with sex offenders, that's objectively
no. He's talking about Drake's overall persistent character over years and years and years and years of behavior, bro. They didn't just meet yesterday. He's known Drake for like 12 years, bro.
What would be the consistent?
He knows people that know Drake. He knows a lot more about Drake than you and me both do. And that's the fucking assessment he came out with.
What's the consistent character flaw of working with sex offenders, by the way? And also,
it's not about working with sex offenders, bro.
If the wife beater thing is also true, on top of that, that speaks fucking really, really bad. So if you're okay with sex offenders and your wife beating, and your wife beating, then yeah, I don't want to hear you moral.
I love how you're running back to things that haven't been proven when I specifically asked you what are great Drake's good points that he made against Kendrick that aren't unprovable things.
I think being a pedophile is worse than all those things.
Me too. But you know, working with somebody who had a rape, like a fucking assault charge. Actually, I looked it up. It was an assault charge. It wasn't a rape charge. But it is what it is. Like, you know, it doesn't make it like much better. I don't know what exactly happened, but
why has Kendrick never gotten that Jay-Z? Because it's speculated pretty heavily, just like Drake, that Jay-Z has been with tons of minors. And he's also like apparently groomed Beyonce. That's like the alleged thing. So on those objective levels, why has he not gotten that Jay-Z?
And Jay-Z is your favorite, so I kind of understand why you're sweeping for Drake.
It's like he might do that next.
You never know.
No, you're just too busy dick sucking. I get it. You're actually just not listening. Okay, cool.
Wait, so you're saying he's wrong for coming at Drake because he didn't come at all these other people. That's your argument right now?
Yeah, I think if you're running an idea of like this is like a moral battle for the world of hip hop, and you want to change the industry like you fucking think he is trying to do.
When you start at the person at the top, Jay-Z's like 50-something years old, has no fucking influence on hip-hop, makes no fucking music. He's not battling Jay-Z. Jay-Z's a fucking dinosaur. What the fuck are you talking about? It's like him fighting with his dad. He's talking to the number one person at the top of the rap game that influences almost everything in hip-hop. That's who he's coming after. And you're like, well, why didn't he come after...
You are just proving
80 years ago. Like, what the fuck?
You have no idea what the fuck you're talking about. If you're saying Jay-Z, of all people, has no influence in the rap world, you objectively lost this argument just based off that alone. Holy shit.
What do you think I was saying when I said that? Emery, let's put our best good faith hats on. What do you think I meant when I said that?
No, you don't get to run out of this. This is like saying Snoop Dogg.
So if he makes a diss track on Jay-Z right now, do you think that would have the same impact of him destroying Drake?
I think it'd be just the same amount of impact, yeah.
Because Jay-Z would definitely respond to that, right? Right?
Jay-Z would have to, yes.
No, he wouldn't. Jay-Z has been retired for 15 fucking years. No, he would not.
It doesn't matter. No, Jay-Z has a reputation.
You might as well call it Dr. Dre. What the fuck are you talking about?
Jay-Z has a reputation.
Drake and Kendrick are compared. And first of all, Drake came at Kendrick first. Let's not forget that.
You're just objectively wrong. You just don't understand anything about the fucking rap world. I get it. You're just objectively
wrong. Why do you keep saying that? Like, do you know who you're talking to? My whole YouTube channel is based off fucking rap. Why do you keep saying I know nothing about rap? Why do you keep saying that? I literally don't understand.
Trash, because you have no idea the amount of influence Jay-Z has, even to this day, retired or not.
You're literally just yapping.
Emery's got a point here, Philly. Like if you didn't have the same opinion as him, you're just wrong.
I never thought
he
of that,
is.
Actually.
No, he's just objectively wrong. If you say
I did not think about that.
This is like saying Dr. Dre doesn't have influence. You're like objectively wrong.
Okay.
Just wrong.
What I meant to
just
say, and what I hope you would understand the point I was making, was that him coming at Jay-Z would not have the same effect as him coming at Drake. Like, can you understand that? Can you understand that's what I meant?
Yes, it actually would have had the same effect, if not a larger impact.
I disagree.
Then you're just, I don't even understand how your brain doesn't compute this.
Okay, I'm because baffled. Jay-Z is almost 60 years old, and
it doesn't matter how
I don't
old
think
he is.
Kendrick did he, coming did he, at did him he, about he, his relationship he, with his current did wife,
been a,
right?
Diddy's been in a rap. Diddy's been in the rap game for a while, and he's getting fucking raided and shit. If Jay-Z got exposed in any
Diddy
significant
just got
way,
done paying millions and millions and millions of dollars in a lawsuit. I don't think Kendrick has to worry about Diddy. Nobody talking about Diddy. Right, his problem is nobody's talking about Drake. Nobody is. Everybody's giving him a pass. There's nobody like actively saying
that's
this is wrong.
You
what
just,
you're doing.
That's just not true at all. Because objectively, earlier you were saying that the culture wasn't feeling Drake, and I agreed with you, and I still agree with you that a lot of people were not feeling Drake because they thought he was a skeevy person. They liked his music, and the music carried. And the reason why his cultural significance is okay. Because he's really good at making songs, and he's really good at like getting people like brand new in the game to like ride a wave. Like he's really good at that, and that's why I
it's
said
almost the
there
opposite
is,
of that. It's almost he rides in and takes their wave. He does not give anybody like he gives them clout. He doesn't give anybody a wave.
I agree.
He rides in and fucking takes.
I agree with you.
And that's also part of the problem that you don't
understand.
I agree with you. So these are all points that Kendrick makes against Drake.
I already agree
Everything
with you.
You just
I'm
so
you,
what is your problem?
I'm telling you, the brand new.
You have all the same criticisms that Kendrick has, but you're upset that he's not making them of other people.
You haven't been listening to me. You've been dick sucking too much.
Wait, then I just fucking say to you exactly what you think.
Did I not say from the word go that I said both parties need receipts to back up their claims and that will make their lines harder? That will make their actual bars harder. Can you back
that.
Me up? Anklemore, can you back me up?
You did I said say that. From, you don't need Kinkle to back you up. You did say that. You did.
And then you came in here.
And I agreed with you. And I said, besides that, what do you have? And you have nothing.
No, you didn't say that, Billy.
I did say that.
He said, if Kendrick doesn't have receipts, this is damaging his reputation. That's
it does.
Said.
I said objectively,
yeah,
that
nothing,
is true.
Nothing,
it does.
No, but you were talking about Kendrick. You weren't talking about both of them lacking receipts. You were talking about Kendrick.
I did that because people were dick-sucking him a lot, yeah.
It was obvious.
Who was dick-sucking him?
Kendrick. So you're
nobody was talking.
Drake. STV, you were in tomfoolery. Wait, we talked
yesterday?
About this already. Yeah.
We talked about yesterday. So you came on Kinklemore's stream today to talk about some shit I said on yesterday's tomfoolery stream when I wasn't even in chat.
I'm pretty sure Rude Mug Crab was talking about this in a dick sucking way as well. So.
He was fucking talking about something completely different, and I even told Kinklemore to mute them because they weren't talking about the fucking rap shit. They were talking about some other shit.
I already saw STV in the comments talking about it, and I figured, here's the glazing, and then I heard Rude Mug Crab.
I didn't even glaze.
And I came in here and I said, "Well,
you're so full of shit, Emery. No one in here was glazing. I said one thing about the whole fucking thing. I don't even like Kendrick or Drake. You're fucking high, dude." How many Red Bulls he had? The fuck?
Nah, I'm chill. I'm good.
He's got to convince himself that he came in here for a reason.
What? Why you chill?
There's nothing going on. We're just
you
listening.
Came in here to spurg out at the chat. That's what you did. Like, be for real. You couldn't type because you had to drive. So you came in here to spurg at the chat.
No, I'm good. I came in Kangle. Here to. Came in here to be objective as much as possible.
Could you say the fucking word one more time?
Since we were talking
fucking
about Kendrick,
objective.
Since we were talking about
I
Kendrick
object.
Specifically,
I object.
Since we were talking about Kendrick specifically in that moment, I said, "Yeah, I think Kendrick needs a little bit more proof and receipts in that very specific moment." Sorry, I didn't clarify. Both parties need proof, like I did, like a little bit later. Anyway, I don't understand the point you're trying to make. Like, oh my God, you didn't.
The same point I've been asking you for the last 30 minutes, and you have not been answering.
Uh-huh.
What good?
Howdy.
Hey guys, did you guys hear that Destiny was on Twitter today and he talked to a bunch of right wing potential white nationalists and they actually had a lot of really crazy things to say? I'm wondering what they said.
Yeah, crazy. I'm probably gonna go over that tomorrow.
I'm not gonna lie.
Oh my shit. We took up all his fucking streaming time arguing about Drake and Kendrick. Sorry.
Okay,
took the whole stream up.
That was all good.
All right.
Well,
wait,
that shit was
hold on.
Kind of.
STV. Okay, I'm gonna calm down.
All right, you know what we're gonna do real quick?
Yeah,
we're gonna finish the songs.
Yeah.
Can I say Can I say one thing before we?
Yeah.
I'm just gonna say one thing.
Yeah, you haven't said much. Right.
Fuck you, my crap. Jesus Christ. Go ahead.
I'm gonna ignore that because I know you haven't been listening.
So okay. Rude.
There was one thing.
His name is rude.
No. Okay. The one thing I have to say is that I don't care who wins or loses. I like the chaos. But if I'm going to take an objective look at both parties, I do need facts. I need these facts to be revealed. I need receipts to say objectively whether or not one person's songs are better, one person's bars are better. That's all I've been saying. I'm sorry I came off as Drake lazing. That was not my intention. I apologize if I hurt feelings. That's all.
Okay. Can I reply to that real quick?
Russ is the best rapper. He owns all of his original records.
Yuck.
He's the best. He's the best. He's the best. Russ W.
Dave, shut up. We have no evidence on anything. So how everyone is judging at the moment is on the bars. So everyone is saying Kendrick wins because he has better bars.
That's subjective.
No one is making.
Anyone can.
Not really.
Anyone can say that about any song, anytime, ever. So
it doesn't. Who want a rap battle is subjective? Holy shit!
Yes, actually, art is not.
Okay, that's called sarcasm. You do not have to explain to me. Thank you.
All right, we're gonna go back
now. Emery. All right, one last thing, Emery. If you're waiting for evidence to come out, well, first catch your breath. And if you're waiting for evidence to come out, do not hold your breath. That's all I got to say. And I'm going to mute myself.
I won't have to catch my breath if I don't feel like I have to yell over people not listening to me. I'm just saying. That's all. That's the only reason I got hyped.
I'm going to mute and listen.
I'm going to leave. I got to go to bed. I've been up so long.
No, it's not Kendrick objectively had better bars, TF.
I'll have a good stream.
Oh.
What?
All right. Well, we're going to watch this 15-second clip and then get back into the songs.
Kendrick, to me, is the most electrifying vocalist of this generation. Would you agree with that?
I absolutely would agree.
Vocalist?
Yeah. Kendrick is at the very top tier of lyricists, not just of this generation, but of all time.
Okay, well, that was not at all what I thought it was going to be. I didn't read the title at all.
Nerdy with Zach Beer and Twitter bots, but your reality can't hide behind Wi-Fi. Your little means is losing steam, they figured you out. The forced opinions is not convincing, y'all need a new route. It's time that you look around on who's around you. Before you figure that you're not alone, ask what Mike would do.
Neve, that would be Busta Rhymes, not Eminem.
True.
Maybe in this song, you shouldn't start by saying,
"Nigga, I said it, I know that you mad. I've emptied the clip over friendlier jabs. You mentioned my seed, now deal with his dad. I gotta go bad, I gotta go bad." Yeah, drop a 50 bag for the mob in a spot. Drop a 50 bag, 29 for the thought. I was really, really trying to keep it PG. I was really, really trying to keep it PG. If you had a set, they give your ass a DP. Two civilian gang in real life, you PC. You know who really bang and set my nigga YG. You know who really bang and set my nigga Chuck T. You know who even bang and set out there at CB. And nigga Cole losing sleep on this, it ain't me. You better have some paperwork or that shit fake T. Can't be rapping by no ratting that we can't read. I mean, it's true, a nigga slimy for my AP. Just like how Metro nigga slimy for his main squeeze.
out here begging for attention, nigga, say please. Always rapping like you about to get the slaves free. You just acting like an activist, it's make-believe. Don't even go back to your hood and plant no money trees. Say you hate the girls I fuck, but what you really mean? I've been with black and white and everything that's in between. You the black messiah, wiping up a mixed queen. And hit vanilla cream to help out with your self-esteem. Also, Bobby shit, I wanna know what Whitney need. All that puppy love was over in y'all late teens. Why you never hold your son and tell him say cheese? We could've left the kids out of this, don't blame me. You a dog and you know it, you just play sweet. Your baby mama Cash was always screaming, save me. You did it dirty all your life, you tryna make peace. I heard that one of them little kids might be day free. Don't make it day freeze. Cause if your GM is your BM secret BD, then this is all making plenty fucking sense to me. Hey, let that shorty breathe. Shake that ass, bitch. Hands on your knees. Hands on your knees. Hands on your knees. Shake that ass for Drake. Now shake that ass for free. Yeah, yeah. We're not that kind of free. I'm talking about my nigga Dave. Yo, man, a Lil K. We call that shit a mini Dre. He always said I overlooked him. I was staring straight. These bars go over Kenny head no matter what I say. I know you like to keep it short, so let me paraphrase. Knew it was smoke when Abel hit us with the serenade. Niggas say, Almost started reaching for my ways. Drop a 50 bag for the mob in a spot. Drop a 50 bag, 29 for the thought.
This guy is so white.
This guy is so white.
Yo, you stop playing around and take this shit serious, like. Niggas is a joke, I take it serious, though.
Yo, look. If Drake shooters doing TikToks, nigga, really shooting in your gang. That's P's brother, y'all ain't getting shit shot, nigga. Can't listen to the stick talking falsetto, saving for a hip hop, nigga. You don't even be at home, dog. You a souvenir out the gift shop, nigga. Still mad about that one hoe. We ain't even fuck. I just lip lock with her. I get acting when it's wartime. I ain't even really let my dick drop, nigga. What the fuck? I heard Rick drop, nigga. Talking something about a nose job, nigga. Ozempic got a side effect of jealousy and doubt. I never told y'all, niggas. Put a nigga in the bars, let a nigga rock. Kinda like your old job, nigga. House sitting on some land, but it's out where no one even really knows. Y'all niggas, bitches gotta drive 2 hours for your pay. I'm just to give a blowjob, nigga. Must have started up a snowball. Cause my last record deal was 400 ends. These days, that's a low bar, nigga.
The beef hey. Bags.
Who's shit. Next on the list? Which one of my so-called niggas? Which one of my so-called niggas? Which one of my
this is mid-verse. It sounds like Addy made it.
Your boss. Addy did make a song. I'm playing that after.
That's why all your friends dip into Atlanta playing just to find a tour guy. Able run your fucking bread, need to buy some more chains for some more guys. Let me find another street nigga I could take to the game court side. Let me get a used Ferrari for a rapper, take the nigga on a horse ride. Anything to take a spotlight off the fact the boss is a drugged out little punk sissy from the north side. Rock him talking shit again. Gas cause you hit my BM first, nigga. Do the math who I was hitting in. I ain't even know you rap still cause they only talking about your fit again. Probably gotta have a kid again for you think of dropping any shit again. Even when you do drop, they gon' say you should've modeled cause it's mid again. Smoking 50, but they should've put you on the first one trying to get it in. Ask Fring if this a good idea, the next time you cut it in a bit again. Shit, leave and tell your leader boy alone before you get your head split again. Pluto shit made me sick to my stomach, we ain't never really been through it. Lena Wayne, he a fucking lame, so I know he had to be an influence. These niggas had a plan and they finally found a way to rope you into it. Two separate albums, this and I just did a cam to it. Nigga skim through it. Me and Savage had the hoes dripping wet, it shows, almost had to swim to it. K dot shit is only hitting hard when Baby King put his pen to it. Ross calling me the white boy and the shit kinda got a ring to it. Cause all these rappers waving white flags while the whole fucking club sing to it. Murder scene on your man tonight, then come to vigil with the candlelight. Body at the fucking body and you know Rick reading my Miranda rights. I'm going on vacation, I hope next time y'all plan it right. Cause you gotta pay for saying my name. Guess now niggas understand the price, man. What? Hey, Kendrick just opened his mouth. Someone go hand him a Grammy right now. Where's your uncle at? Cause I wanna talk to the man of the house. West Coast niggas do fades, right? Come get this ass whooping, I'm handing them out. You wanna take off for real? Then come get his legacy out of my house. A cease and desist is for hoes. Can't listen to lies that come out of your mouth. You call the Tupac estate. Then beg them to sue me and get that shit down. I'm losing perspective on beef. Boy, when the same beat and I kill you for fun. Your daddy got robbed by Top. You stunning and Wayne like father, like son. Anthony set up the plays. Kojo be charging you double for none. They shook about what I'ma say.
But texting your phone like we already won. You tell me what I shouldn't say. But fuck it, my nigga, it's already done. We already know it's a 20v1. We already know why you went number one. It's clearly because of the boy. The honorable thing is to give me the loot. You right about fuck the big three. It's only Big D and it's video proof. Our son should go play at the park. Two light-skinned kids, this shit would be cute. Unless you don't wanna be seen with anyone that isn't blacker than you. We get it, we got it. The blacker the berry, the sweeter.
Oh my god. This didn't click before. What he just said clicked, and I want to kill myself. When he said, you're right about the big three, it's only Big D and there's video proof. He's talking about his dick, isn't he? He's like, I didn't even think, I just thought he was talking about himself and then something else. It didn't actually click until just now. He's talking about his dick. I want to kill myself. Obviously, people say Big D for dick, but I forgot about the dick pic or the dick video. It's so stupid. I hate it. Ugh. It just ruined the beat. It just ruined it. The beat's not even good anymore.
Why did you move to New York? Is it because you live in that bachelor life? Proposed in 2015. But don't want to make her your actual wife. I'm guessing this wedding ain't happening right. Because we know the girls that you actually like. The darkest secrets are coming to light. It's all on your face like what happened to Mike. Oh, shit. It's all making sense. Maybe I'm Prince and you actually Mike. Michael was praying his features would change. So people believe that he's actually white. Top will make you do features for change. Get on pop records and rap for the whites. And wait, you say your brother Jermaine. But you want him to stay out of the light. Oh shit,
true.
Just follow me right. Cause nothing you saying could bother me right. I get off the plane and nothing has changed. I handed the Lala with all of my ice. Handed the Lala with all of my ice. Handed the Lala with all of my ice. This shit gotta be over by now. For anyone out here that's calling it right. You're dead. You're dead. There's nowhere to hide, there's nowhere to hide, you know what I mean. They hired a crisis management team to clean up the fact that you beat on your queen. The picture you paint, it ain't what it seems. You're dead.
I will say,
juice, when you put your hands on
this,
your girl, is it self-defense because she's bigger than you?
That kind of made me laugh when I heard it the first time.
Dear Adonis, I'm sorry that that man is your father, let me be honest. It takes a man to be a man, your dad is not responsive. I look at him and wish your grandpa would have wore a condom. I'm sorry that you gotta grow up and then stand
fuck
behind
you,
life is hard, I know. The challenges always go
I'm not sleeping.
Sometimes our parents make mistakes that affect us until we grown. And you're a good kid that need good leadership.
The narcolepsy is not taking over today.
Since your daddy don't teach you shit. Never let a man piss on your leg, son. Either you die right there or pop that man in the head, son. Never fall in the escort business. That's bad religion. Please remember, you could be a bitch even if you got bitches. Never code switch, whether right or wrong. You're a black man, even if it don't benefit your goals. Do some push-ups, get some discipline. Don't cut them corners like your daddy did. Fuck what Ozempic did. Don't pay to play with them Brazilians. Get a gym membership. Understand, no throwing rocks and hiding hands. That's law. Don't be ashamed about who you with. That's how he treats your moms. Don't have a kid to hide a kid to hide again. Be sure 5% will comprehend, but 95 is lost. Be proud of who you are. Your strength come from within. A lot of superstars, that's real.
Oh,
but
no, I know.
One of them, and you nothing like him. You'll carry
minutes.
Yourself as king. Can't understand me right now. Just play this when you 18. Dear Sandra, your son got some habits. I hope you don't undermine them. Especially with all the girls that's hurt inside this climate. You a woman, so you know how it feels to be in alignment. With emotions, hoping a man can see you and not be blinded. Dear Dennis, you gave birth to a master manipulator. Even using you to prove who he is a huge favor. I think you should ask for more paper, and more paper, and more...
more paper. I'm blaming you for all his gambling addictions. Psychopath intuition, the man that liked to play victim. You raised a horrible fucking person. The nerve of you, Dennis. Sandra, sit down. What I'm about to say is heavy. Now listen. Your son's a sick man with sick thoughts. I think niggas like him should die. Him and Weinstein should get fucked up in a cell for the rest of their life. He hates black women, hypersexualizing with kinks of a nympho fetish. Grew facial hair because he understood being a beard just fit him better. He got sex offenders on HOVO that he keep on a monthly allowance. And a child should never be compromised, and he keeping his child around him. And we gotta raise our daughters knowing there's predators like him lurking. Fuck a rap battle, he should die so all of these women can live with a purpose. I've been in this industry 12 years, I'ma tell y'all one little secret. It's some weird shit going on, and some of these artists be here to police it. They be streamlining victims on the side of their home and calling them tender. Then leak videos of themselves to further push their agendas. To any woman that be playing this music, know that you're playing your sister. Or better yet, selling your niece to the weirdos, not the good ones. Cat Williams, I gave you the truth, so I'ma get mine. The embassy about to get raided too. It's only a matter of time.
Yeah, Henry, I said this earlier. I feel like if that is true and Drake created this story, he kind of played himself. He kind of really played himself. He just did the dumbest possible thing he could have done. He's like pretending to be like this mob boss type genius, and he came out looking like a retard that likes fucking wannabe intelligent, like, movie cliches.
Hey, LeBron, keep the family away. Hey, Curry, keep the family away. To anybody that embody the love for their kids, keep the family away. They looking at you too if you standing by him. Keep the family away. I'm looking to shoot through any pervert that lives. Keep the family safe. Dear baby girl, I'm sorry that your father not active inside your world. He don't commit to much but his music, yeah, that's for sure. He a narcissist, misogynist, living inside his songs. Try to destroy families rather than taking care of his own. Should be teaching you timetables or watching Frozen with you. Or at your 11th birthday, singing poems with you. Instead, he being Turks, paying for sex and popping perks. Examples that you don't deserve. I want to tell you that you're loved, you're brave, you're kind. You got a gift to change the world and can change your father's mind. Cause our children is the future, but he lives inside confusion. Money's always been illusion, but that's the life he's used to. His father probably didn't claim him neither. History do repeats itself. Sometimes it don't need a reason. But I would like to say it's not your fault that he's hiding another child. Give him grace. This the reason I made Mr. Morale. So our babies like you can cope later. Give you some confidence to go through something. It's hope later. I never want to hear you chasing man cause it's felt behavior. Sitting in the club with sugar daddies for validation. You need to know that love is eternity and trumps all pain. I tell you who your father is, just play this song when it rains. Yes, he's a hit maker, songwriter, superstar, right? And a fucking deadbeat that should never say more life. Meet the Grams. Dear Harbor, I know you probably thinking I wanted to crash your party, but truthfully I don't have a hating bone in my body. This supposed to be a good exhibition within the game, but you fucked up the moment you called out my family's name. Why you had to stoop so low to discredit some decent people? Guess integrity is lost when the metaphors doesn't reach you. And I like to understand cause your house was never for a home. 37, but you showing up as a 7-year-old. You got gambling problems, drinking problems, pill popping and spending problems. Bad with money, whorehouse, soliciting women problems. Therapy's a lovely start, but I suggest some ayahuasca. Strip the ego from the bottom. I try to empathize with you, cause I know that you ain't been through nothing. Crave entitlement, but wanna be like so bad that it's puzzling. No dominance, let's recap moments when you didn't fit in. No secret handshakes with your friend, no culture cachet to binge. Just disrespecting your mother, identity's on the fence. Don't know which family would love you. The skin that you living in is compromised and personas. Can't channel your masculine even when standing next to a woman. You a body shamer, you go hide them baby mamas, ain't ya? You embarrassed of them, that's not right, that ain't
ain't how mama raised us. Take that mask off. I wanna see what's under them achievements. Why believe you? You never gave us nothing to believe in. Cause you lied about religious views. You lied about your surgery. You lied about your accent and your past tense. All is perjury. You lied about your ghost riders. You lied about your crew members. They all pussy. You lied on them. I know they all got you in them. You lied about your son. You lied about your daughter, huh? You lied about them other kids that's out there hoping that you come. You lied about the only artist that can offer you some help. Fuck a rap battle. This a long life battle with yourself. Psst. I see dead people.
Mother on that beat, no.
Aye. Mustard on the beat, ho. Debo, any rap nigga, he a free throw. Man damn, call a Amber Lambs, tell him breathe, bro. Nail a nigga to the cross, he walk around like Tizo. What's up with these jabroni ass niggas trying to see Compton? The industry can hate me, fuck them all and they mama. How many ops you really got? I mean, it's too many options. I'm finna pass on this body, I'm John Stockton. Beat your ass and hide the Bible if God watching. Sometimes you gotta pop out and show niggas. Certified boogeyman, I'm the one that up to score with him. Walk him down whole time, I know he got some hoe in him. Pull on him, extort shit, bully the floor on him. Say Drake, I hear you like I'm young. You better not ever go to cell block one. To any bitch that talk to him and they in love, just make sure you hide your little sister from him. They tell me Chubb's the only one that get your hand-me-downs. And party at the party playing with his nose now. And Baka got a weird case, why is he around? Certified lover boys, certified pedophiles. Wop, 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 wop. Dot, fuck him up. Wop, 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 wop. I'ma do my stuff. Why you trolling like a bitch? Ain't you tired? Trying to strike a chord, and it's probably A minor. They not like us. 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 You think the Bay gon' let you disrespect Pop, nigga? I think that Oakland show gon' be your last stop, nigga. They cold foul. I don't know why you still pretending. What is the owl? Bird niggas and bird bitches. Go. The audience not dumb. Shape the stories how you want. Hey, Drake, they're not slow. Rabbit hole is still deep. I can go further, I promise. Ain't there something? Be rest. That's for bitching. You Malibu most wanted. Ain't no law boy. You ball boy. Fetch Gatorade or something. Since 2009, I had this bitch jumping. You niggas will get a wedgie. Be flipped over your boxes. Or over your foe. The other vaginal option. Pussy. Nigga better straighten they posture. Got famous all up in content. Might write this with a doctor. Tell a pop star quit hiding. Fuck a caption, won't action. No accident, I'm hands on. He fuck around, get polished. Fucked on Wayne girl while he was in jail. That's conniving. Then get his face tatted like a bitch apologizing. I'm glad D Rose came home. Y'all didn't deserve him neither. From Alondra down to Central. Nigga better not speak on Serena. And your homeboy needs subpoena. That predator moving flocks. That name gotta be registered and placed on neighborhood watch. I lean on you niggas like another line of walk. Yeah, it's all eyes on me and I'ma send it up the park. Ay, put the roll label on me, I'ma get them dropped. Ay, sweet chin music and I won't pass the ox. Ay, how many stocks do I really have in stock? Ay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Crip walking RN.
Devil is a lie, here 69 God. Ay, freaky ass niggas need to stay their ass inside. Ay, roll their ass up like a fresh pack of Zon. Ay, city is back up, it's a must, we outside. Ay. They not like us. 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 Once upon a time, all of us was in chains. Homies still doubled down, calling us some slaves. Atlanta was the mecca, building railroads and trains. Bear with me for a second, let me put y'all on game. The settlers was using town folk to make them richer. Fast forward 2024, you got the same agenda. You run to Atlanta when you need a check balance. Let me break it down for you, this the real nigga challenge. You caught Future when you didn't see the club. Like, what? Lil Baby help you get your lingo up. What? 21, get your first street cred. Thug make you feel like you a slime in your head. Like, what? Quavo said you can be from Northside. But 2 Chainz say you good, but he lied. You run to Atlanta when you need a few dollars. No, you're not a colleague, you a fucking colonizer. The family matter and the truth of the matter. Here was God's plan to show y'all the liar. He a fan, he a fan, he a fan. He a fan, he a fan, he a freaky ass nigga, he a 69 God. Freaky ass nigga, he a 69 God. Hey, 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 run for your life. Hey, 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 run for your life. Freaky ass nigga, he a 69 God. Freaky ass nigga, he a 69 God. Hey, 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 run for your life. Hey, 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 run for let your life. Let me hear you say O V ho.
O V ho.
Say O V ho.
O V ho.
Then step this way, step that way. Then step this way, step that way. Are you my friend? Are we locked in? Then step
this way, step that way, then step this way, step that way.
And now for some diarrhea.
It's a prize winner, it's definitely spiraling. I got your fucking lines tapped, I swear that I'm dialed in. First I was a rat, so where's the proof of the trial then? Where's the paperwork of the cabinet is filed in? 1090 Jake would've took all the walls down. The streets would've had me hiding out in a small town. My Montreal connect stand up, not far down.
Oh shit. Kendrick, you a liar and a manipulator. Drake, I lied to and manipulated you.
The ones that you're getting your stories from, they all clowns. I am a
that's
war general,
funny.
Season in preparation. My jacket is covered in medals, honor and decoration. You waited for this moment, overcome with the desperation. We plotted for a week and then we fed you the information. A daughter that's 11 years old, I bet he takes it. We thought about giving a fake name or a destination. But you so thirsty, you not concerned with investigation. Instead, you in that Venice studio, it's a celebration. You gotta learn to fact check things and be less impatient. Your fans are rejoicing, thinking this is my expiration. Even the picture you use, the jokes and the medication, the Maybach glove and the drug he uses for less inflation. Master manipulator, you bit on a speculation. You dumb and reactive nigga, I'm petty with dedication. What about the bones we dug up in that excavation? And why isn't Whitney denying all of the allegations? Why is she following Dave Free and not Mr. Morale? You haven't seen the kids in 6 months, the distance is wild. Dave leaving heart emojis underneath pics of the child. Speaking of anything with a child, let's get to that now. This Epstein angle was the shit I expected. TikTok videos you collected and dissected. Instead of being on some disdirect shit, you rather fucking grab your pen and misdirect shit. My mom came over today and I was like, mother, I, wait a second. That's that one record where you say you got molested. Oh, fuck me, I just made the whole connection. This about to get so depressing. This is trauma from your own confessions. This when your father leave you home alone with no protection, so neglected. That's why these pedophile raps and shit you so obsessed with, it's so excessive. They acting like it's so aggressive, but you just never known affection. I don't wanna diss you anymore, this really got me second guessing. Touch my body by Mariah Carey play, you probably start reflecting. I never been with no one underage, but now I understand why this the angle that you really mess with. Just for clarity, I feel disgusted. I'm too respected. If I was fucking young girls, I promise I'd have been arrested. I'm way too famous for the shit you just suggested, but that's not the lesson. Clearly, there's a deeper message. Deep cuts that never healed and now they got infected. Like if Dave really fucked your girl and got her pregnant. Talk about breeding resentment. Not sure how to ease the sentiment, the shit's too intimate. I'm praying you recover from both incidents. But you a piece of shit, so this shit really no coincidence. Drake is not a name that you gon' see on no sex offender list. Easy does it. You mentioned an A minor, but niggas gotta be sharp and tell the fans who was it. You thought you left D flat, D major. I slit your throat with the razor and do Rick Ross hair like that one flight from Malaysia. I'm your baby mama screensaver. Only fucking with Whitney's, not Millie Bobby Brown's. I never look twice at no teenager. I'm a fucking hit maker, dawg, not a peacemaker. Yeah, bullets that I'm stuffing in each chamber. Your ass in extreme danger. Stop buying views and buy comments. You may as well keep the paper. Shit you about to need for later. I give a fuck about your streaming data. You could drop 100 more records, I'll see you later. Yeah, maybe when you meet Jamaica. I don't wanna fight with a woman beater. It feeds your nature. If you still bumping R. Kelly, you could thank the savior. Said if they deleted his music, then your music is going to a hypocrite. I don't understand why these people praise you. Sounding like you sent him commissary when he needs some paper. Album dropping soon, no wonder you turn a clout chaser instead of doing hard labor. Nigga, I see you when I see you like Fantasia. Whitney, you can hit me if you need a favor. And when I say I hit your back, it's a lot safer. I promise. Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, this shit was some good exercise. Like, it's good to get out, get the pen working. You would be a worthy competitor if I was really a predator and you weren't fucking lying to every blogger and editor, but it is what it is. You definitely got this shit burnt the fuck out, though. Like, you got 10 more records to drop. The one before the last one, we finessed you into telling a story that doesn't even exist.
and then you go and drop the West Coast one to try and cover that up. I would like that one. That would be some shit I could dance to if you wasn't tripling down on some whole other bullshit. But, you know, at least your fans are getting some raps out of you. I'm happy I can motivate you, bring you back to the game, like, you know, but just let me know when we get into the facts. Everything in my shit is facts. I'm waiting on you to return the favor, like.
Wake up.
Funny. You should just quit after five. True. I was
so what's the other
before?
Like, what are the
anymore?
What are the rap and hip hop reactors? Like, what's that sector think about this stuff?
I think academics is the only one that that liked it. Wait, hold on.
They got me feeling like I'm academics. Can't ride away. Joe sleeping, man. Probably cuddling with his shorty.
Yo.
Oh shit! I thought you was in like a strip club or something right now. Yo, Joe.
Yo.
Yeah, I'm on the stream, and I gotta get some quick thoughts on you. Just a minute or two, man. What's the vibes?
I'm over it.
You're over it?
I'm over it.
How are you over it?
Shit's exhausting. I'm done. I'm in bed.
What do you think about the drop from last night to tonight? There, it feels like this is more about speed. What do you feel like is going on right now?
Too much. I just feel like too much is going on. Like, yesterday was a lot. Today, Drake sounds exhausted. It's like I'm exhausted. I feel him. I don't blame him. I don't know what's going on. I want these niggas to stop. I'm over it now.
Well, if you're saying that, we're going to start talking about a winner, right?
Well, we know the winner.
Do we?
All right, I'm not doing this with you right now. Okay. Who's the winner? If it ends right now.
If it ends right now, are we counting the lies or not?
Oh my God. Yes. So, we're counting all the lies. It's okay to lie.
Oh man. Well, it's not over yet, Joe. It's not over yet. It's not over yet, motherfucker. Hey, honestly, hey, listen, this goes on until the rightful winner wins. It's one of those. Hey, it's like when the NBA got some shit going on. Like, where are they about to lose? All right, another overtime. Come on, let's get it right. It's like the NFL.
When are you gonna get some rest?
Oh no, I'm well rested. Like, I mean, actually, I've been losing my voice consistently for like last 5 days. But, yo, you know what? I've been thinking as MCs, like, what the fuck are they doing? Like, are they having a good time, or are they just literally stuck in a studio being like a slave to our unrealistic demands for really quick records?
I think Kendrick might have been in the studio anyway. I think Drake is getting annoyed with having to go to a studio to answer to this bullshit.
He's probably in the embassy chilling. Like, the studio's probably in his room.
Yeah, that's true, too. But he didn't sound happy that he had to go in a booth and address any of that shit.
Yeah, well, I think it was a subject matter he had to address. Yo, you just made a possible outside song, and you're talking about me on a level that I don't want to be discussed on.
Yeah, I wanted the battle to end after Not Like Us. Like, what I learned today is I like Drake on offense and not defense. And this battle, for some reason, has put him on defense, and I don't love it.
I don't think Drake ends this on defense. I think Drake had to do a defensive move to go on offense. So I actually think he's about to get back on offense.
Yeah, but some of that shit he said tonight, in terms of the T, it was just reminiscent of some of the shit he said in Family Matters. It was like, if there's no more T and there's nothing really more to be said about the nigga, then it's like I told you last night, rap and then head off into the sunset on a horse. Like, there's nothing more to say, there's nothing more to do. Like, the people that think Drake won already think Drake won. The people that got their mind made up on Kendrick, they already feel that way. We got some great music out of this shit. Kendrick gave us a dance bop, like, but if he ain't gonna put one of them beats on and just go ham on this nigga, then I don't want to keep hearing Drake have to defend his legacy.
Yeah, me as a fan, I either want maybe another rappity rap song, or I want a hit song, or I want him to.
Did this dude just say rappity rap song? Is he 5 years old? Is he teaching kindergarten? I thought he was a rap reactor. What's going on?
You transition out of this. I want to die. He transitioned out of that Pusha T shit, which is,
I mean, he does agree with Red Pillars for the most part. So, like, I'm not that surprised. He's retarded.
Is drop 18 hits simultaneously because.
Okay, well then.
I do think people are thinking that they're like, maybe he's affected, even if there is, let's say part of the culture that felt he didn't get the better of this, you know, back and forth. I personally think his career is not affected. And I think anytime shit like this happens, he just drops 10 hits and let's keep it moving.
All right. Well, if that's the game plan, I'd like to see him do that too.
Okay. Okay.
We got our money's worth out of this. This was good.
I was trying to ask Elliot Wilson earlier, yo, has there been any other battle where either the responses has came in quicker succession? It's been 5 rounds each. So there's 10 songs that we could discuss.
If there was, I certainly don't know it. I don't remember a time. I can't remember this ever happening at this pace.
Interesting. Yeah. Well,
now with two of the biggest dudes, now with the two biggest dudes at this pace, we never got there.
Yeah. Well, I mean, listen, I enjoyed it. I honestly hope it continues, but maybe not continues at this breakneck speed. I think we both were on the same page. We're like, yo, I think Drake has afforded himself the idea or opportunity to drop in 3 weeks or a month at this point, yo. Like,
yeah, Philly, I saw that on Twitter a minute ago. That was funny as fuck.
This breakneck speed shit is like, you know, we still haven't even appreciated the genius from the Family Matters joint.
Is that crazy, though?
I know.
Look at the guy. He looks like he don't like leaving his seat.
I played it today, though.
Now, I've been appreciating more with Tom. I played a bunch today. So, I don't know, man.
Listen, man, get some fucking rest. Don't let these rappers fucking ruin your sleep schedule.
Oh, no, I love this. I kind of love it.
I'm glad you do, though. But I'm over these niggas. I'm over it. I'm off it. I guess I can't.
All right.
Yeah.
Here's this. Here's Addy.
Kendrick Lamar, you ain't even close to.
Yo, Eddie, if you want to come into the Discord sometime, bro, I'll teach you how to, like, use Photoshop and shit. Shorties like you always hang on light skins while your coat is the color of a cigar. My son Adonis going to outgrow me before he's 12. Keep talking about my son, pop your head with six shells. Kendrick Lamar's headshot, leave a blood trail. Weirdo talking about my BBL. This little rat ain't ready. Don't look at me when we in the same celly. I'm straight, but I do you know R. Kelly. Full grown hobbit, worried about another man's belly. Can't die, where's Pops? You wanna smoke, you gon' end up like Tupac. Son Adonis said wait till he 18, he gon' fuck you up. Can't die, don't duck, models we hear, what's up? Your baby mamas ain't a ratchet from the hood. How come I can't say the N-word when you hate your own mama? You hate them big Section 8 balloons, oh. T-Rex arms, you can't reach. Your last diss track you kinda reached. Mad at yourself because my skin is bleached. We can box your baby hands kinda weak. You at the mills.
EBT Lamar AI Drake. What the fuck? What I see. Oh, Kendrick, the next track. My god. Will be leaked. EBT Lamar. EBT Lamar. RP body in the graveyard. What was Destiny wearing? This? I didn't see this, but I saw the photo of it. The Afghan.
Where's my thing? I got a thing. I don't even know how to. I thought it was gonna come like already shaped. But it's not shaped already. I don't know how the fuck I'm supposed to. I'll figure it out at some point. And I got it in blue, because I like blue. Lisan, Al Gab, Gabe. What's it called? How does it go? Lisan.
The way you put that fucking thing on.
Lisan, Al Gabe, I Haib. What's it called? And I got it in blue, because I like blue.
I don't know how to fucking put it on, but I know that's definitely not fucking Al. That was so stupid. Oh, that's brutal. That's so funny. Oh my god. Oh, you're right, Philly. You should drop a diss track on Destiny just for that one. Just for that.
In blue, because I like blue. Because I like blue. Blue, because I like blue.
Oh my god.
Lisan, Al Gab. And I got it in blue, because I like blue. And I got it in blue, because I like blue.
That's just too good.
Lisan, Al Gab, Gabe. What's it called? How does it go? Lisan. Lisan, Al Gaib. I Haib. I don't remember doing two.
Lycan wears them.
I'll try to wear this. I'll wear it to my debate tomorrow, okay? Do you think the general public thinks the protests and everything around them looks good? I mean, they're stirring up a lot of commotion, right?
Aunt Jemima ass?
Really, also, apparently...
What?
Nothing else going on.
Fucking
domestically or internationally, but this
fucking
right now, forever.
Christ. Oh, shit.
I went to school for telecommunications, but you gotta understand, telling is the first thing I went to school for, telling. So I'll tell you a story. So one day I was chilling with my friend Aubrey, right?
Aubrey.
And we were in like my Canadian match, we were chilling with my friend Aubrey. He was like, yo, There's one kid that's bothering me, and I think I'm going to kill him. And I'm like, yo, what are you talking about, guy? We don't kill people at this level. And it's like, yeah, there's one kid. His name is like X or something like that. But I didn't know anything about it. I didn't really listen to these rappers. So come to find out, the kid died. The kid died. Later on, the kid died. And then...
Oh, yeah, I haven't played this on stream yet. Either of these. Addy made two songs about me. He made one song at once. Remix. They call him Kinklemore and knock off Macklemore. I forgot about these. Like they have sausage fingers touching them Pokemon cards. His bestie rubbed my crab and Eve both have smoky looking. I didn't really look at the background. Now back to Kinkle's Pokemon cards. You don't even have a Charizard. Yellow like Pikachu, ice colored jaundice. Apparently I have jaundice eyes. These look like jaundice. Second one's way better. Way better.
What the fuck? Kinklemore. Kinkle
stars knock knock. Who's at the door? It's Ash catching back. Me and my jaundice eyes. And my swollen hands. Okay. I'm just going to go to the second one. The rest is pretty much a repeat.
Hey, Ryan, you alive, dude?
He's sleeping.
AJ trains savage Pokemon.
This he shit kind of bangs. Gym.
He's never lost a single match.
This shit kind of bangs.
Until now. He hasn't come up against somebody like me.
He's getting a big head.
Yeah, but his brain still is sized. Knock off Macklemore, hands look like they have stars. Sausage fingers touching them Pokemon cards. His dusty rub mud crab and knee. Both half smuggy looking noses also get no holes. Now back to Kangol's Pokemon cards. You don't even have a Charizard.
No, I don't smoke anymore. Eyes colored jaundice. Ripping open them Pokemon packs. One by one, nothing but trash. No hollows, just rares and commons. Pokemon game fussy like a stash. Let's be honest, you and mud crab. Once a taste of Meve's cat. Oh wait. Gengumor, Gengusaurus, knock knock, who's at the door? It's Ash Ketchum. Gotta catch them all. Oh. It's Ash Ketchum, gotta catch them all. I got a couple, alright? I got a couple different Charizards.
I don't see any beautiful girl.
Just turn around.
Misty, please, only one of us can hallucinate at a time. It's
Ash Ketchum. Brutal. Gotta
catch them all. That's fucked.
That's so fucked. But so funny. That had me dying. It's so fucked, but so fucking funny. Oh.
Number one fan, your first number one. I had to put it in your hand. You pussies can't get booked outside America for now. I'm out in Tokyo because I'm big in Japan. I'm the hit maker, y'all depend on. Backstage in my city, it was friend zone. You won't ever take no chain off of us. How the fuck you big stepping with a size 7 men's on? It's the bark with the bite, fuck, what's up? I know my picture on the wall when y'all cook up. Explosion, baby, whole career you been shook up. Cause Todd told you drop and give me 50 likes and push-ups, huh? Your last one brick, you really not on shit. They make excuses for you cause they hate to see me lit. Pull your contract cause we gotta see the split. The way you doing splits, bitch, your pants might rip. You better do that motherfucking show inside the bitty. Maroon 5 need a verse, you better make it witty. Then we need a verse for the Swizzies. Top say drop, you better drop and give them 50. Hey, better drop and give me 50.
drop and give me 50, drop and give me 58. Bitches really got me out here talking like I'm 58.
Okay, I'm gonna do two more things. Whoops.
Okay. Struggling to tell you about a person that a person you might know. He has his blue light shades on and he's learning to go. I think he's ready to go. He's done working.
You're right, Neve. AI is super talented. All right. I'm just going to play Not Like Us one more time, and then I'm going to go to bed because I got to be up. This shit is just fire. Ooh, hold on.
Psst. What? How?
This is gonna be retarded.
I see dead people.
Hey, monster on the beat, ho, Debo, any rap nigga, he a free throw. Man damn, call her Amber Lambs, tell him breathe, bro. Nail a nigga to the cross, he walk around like Tizo. What's up with these jabroni ass niggas trying to see Compton? The industry can hate me, fuck them all in the mama. How many ops you really got? I mean, it's too many options. I'm finna pass on this body, I'm John Stockton. Sometimes you gotta pop out and show niggas. Certified boogeyman, I'm the one that up to score with him. Walk him down whole time, I know he got some hoe in him. Pull on him, extort shit, bully the flow on him. Say Drake, I hear you like I'm young. You better not ever go to cell block one. To any bitch that talk to him and they in love, just make sure you hide your little sister from him. They tell me Chubb's the only one that get your hand-me-downs. And party at the party playing with his nose now. And Baka got a weird case, why is he around? Certified lover boy, certified pedophiles. Wop, 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 wop. That fuck him up. Wop, 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 wop. I'ma do my stuff. Why you trolling like a bitch? Ain't you tired? Trying to strike a chord, and it's probably A minor. They not like us. 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 You think the Bay gon' let you disrespect Pop, nigga? I think that Oakland show gon' be your last stop, nigga. They cold foul. I don't know why you still pretending. What is the owl? Bird niggas and bird bitches. Go. The audience not dumb. Shape the stories how you want. Hey, Drake, they're not slow. Rabbit hole is still deep. I can go further, I promise. Ain't there something?
It is.
That's for bitching. You Malibu most wanted. Ain't no law boy, you ball boy. Fetch Gatorade or something. Since 2009, I had this bitch jumping. You niggas will get a wedgie. Be flipped over your boxes. Well, over your foe. The other vaginal option. Pussy. Nigga better straighten they posture. Got famous all up in contact. Might write this with a doctor. Tell a pop star quit hiding. Fuck a caption, won't action. No accident, I'm hands on. He fuck around, get polished. Fucked on Wayne girl while he was in jail. That's conniving. Then get his face tatted like a bitch apologizing. I'm glad D-Rose came home. Y'all didn't deserve him either. From Alondra down to Central. Nigga better not speak on Serena. And your homeboy needs subpoena. That predator moving flocks. That name gotta be registered and placed on neighborhood watch. I lean on you niggas like another line of walk. Yeah, it's all eyes on me and I'ma send it up the pot. Ay, put the roll label on me, I'ma get them dropped. Ay, sweet chin music and I won't pass the ox. Ay, how many stocks do I really have in stock? Ay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 plus 5. Ay, devil is a lie. He's 69 God. Ay, freaky ass niggas need to stay ass inside. Ay, roll their ass up like a fresh pack of Zon. Ay, city is back up. It's a must. We outside. Ay. They not like us. 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 Once upon a time, all of us was in chains. Homies still doubled down, calling us some slaves. Atlanta was the mecca, building railroads and trains. Bear with me for a second, let me put y'all on game. The settlers was using town folk to make them richer. Fast forward 2024, you got the same agenda. You run to Atlanta when you need a check balance. Let me break it down for you, this the real nigga challenge. You caught future when you didn't see the club. Hey, what? Lil baby help you get your lingo up. What? 21, get your first street cred. Thug, I'm you feel like you a slime in your head. Hey, what? Quavo said you can be from Northside, but 2 Chainz say you good, but he lied. You run to Atlanta when you need a few dollars. No, you're not a colleague, you a fucking colonizer. The family matter and the truth of the matter. Here was God's plan to show y'all the liar. He a fan, he a fan, he a fan. He a fan, he a fan, he a freaky ass nigga, he a 69 God. Freaky ass nigga, he a 69 God. Hey, 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 run for your life. Hey, 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 run for your life. Freaky ass nigga, he a 69 God. Freaky ass nigga, he a 69 God. Hey, 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 run for your life. Hey, 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 run for
let
your life.
Let me hear you say O-V-O.
O-V-O.
Say O-V-O.
O-V-O. O-V-O.
Oh my God.
Step that way, then step this way. Step that way. Are you my friend? Are we locked in? Then step this way. Step that way. Then step this way. Step that way.
Okay, that was it. That was a decent song. Chat, hold on, chat. Yes, I gotta process some of that.
In the bylaws.
18 million.
Always looking at the bylaws. Alicia.
That song, 18 million.
Wait. No. No fucking way.
The bylaws. Yeah, we already knew this, though. We already knew this.
Wait, what?
The bylaws.
City lets Drake build fences twice as high as set out in bylaws due to security concerns.
Yeah, we already knew this, though. We already knew this. I thought we already knew about the fence height. The fuck? Bro. Oh, it's commonly referred as doxing on
this
the internet.
How do we do the Google Earth shit? Nah, Drake, you gotta shoot this nigga, man.
So, on the internet,
no, I'm joking.
It's doxing. Honestly, legally, it's joking. Not. Because if something is reasonably obtainable through the fucking public channels, it won't be judged as doxing. It's a bit blurry, depending on your state.
I don't know if anybody's seen this other shit. This had me dying. I wonder if I could just... Drake's house on Google Maps says owned by Kendrick. And then below it. Oh, that's not good. Okay, it's his whole address. Kendrick's son house, Kendrick's dog. Kendrick's dog's bath. See. Certified Kid Lover. Drake's A Hoe For Real.
That's wild.
That's crazy. Kendrick's dog bark.
God, I love the fucking internet sometimes.
There we go. Daughter's quarters? What the fuck? Money trees? Oh. That's funny. It's another reference. Kendrick's house. Let's see. How many times I can drop a pin and it changes the name. Certified Kid Lover. Yoshi Ain't 18. Oh my God. A PDF house. Oh shit. Ugh. Okay. Epstein's Island? Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. Oh, that's crazy. Bridal path. Let me see if I can just... Oh, that one didn't come up. This was the one that said it was his house. Looks like this ain't it. This is definitely it. It's this one. Right? This is the one with the wall. Yeah. Yeah, this ain't it. That's crazy. That's so crazy. Certified Kid Lover, and it's a public bathroom. Oh, Drake's a hoe for real. It's a playground. And they updated the photo since I started clicking on this. Five photos. I need the max win.
On me when I walked near the house.
Child has been missing here for the past week. Awesome playground, though strange. The light-skinned man with a beard wouldn't let the children in his house come out to play. My God. BBL Drizzy. My God. All right. I think it's time for me to go to bed.
Yeah, it is. Ryan already beat you there.
Yeah, it's about to be 7. All right. Well, that was funny. That's crazy. Just shooting a corpse.
So the most interesting part of this was Emery spurging.
True, that's I'm not gonna pretend like that's not gonna be covered tomorrow.
Oh yeah.
That is 100% getting covered tomorrow.
Why isn't anyone listening to me?
Oh my God. Kendrick's bathroom. Come to Papa.
Papa.
When I zoom out. Kendrick's bitch. Kendrick's forest. Certified PDF. Come to Papa. Daughter's quarters. CPS Canada. Drizzy's twerk chamber.
Oh yeah, Resto, you missed this bag.
Kendrick's tree.
You missed the white guy telling the black guy whose channel is basically all about rap that he doesn't know rap. It was a legendary. No, Emery's white. He looks like Tom.
Kendrick Summerhouse. I like, oh my God. Grams. Something. Fuck. Ovi host children camp.
I'm Caucasian.
That's crazy, bro. Next you're gonna tell me you're white, then Kegel. Yeah, I know, it was crazy. That would be crazy. I'm actually incredibly black. You remember Apex told me that I'm black now? He gave me his card. Remember? Remember?
Oh, true. And you haven't even used it. That's so disrespectful to the black community.
Today? Always. Every day. Based.
Studio with Kendrick when you record.
Nah, he sent me the verse like, yo.
I wanna green light, I wanna be like, I wanna press my.
I always thought that, yo, this song's so good. Yo, when that dude hit the high note, I was like, oh my God.
Put the pussy on the pedestal. Put the pussy on the high.
I
I think he make RBTs when he go in. Like, we about to do this Travis verse. We about to do all these verses and just line up everybody grave sites.
Buy the building, burn the building, take your bitch, rebuild the building just to fuck some.
I be wanting to call him like, yo, who you mad at, bro? And that's why he the greatest artist, man. Because he got that focus of like, I don't care if it's a feature. Man, I'm treating this like it's my song. Barn ends out.
Be the pipe of pick your peppers. I can pick your brain and put your heart together.
I don't, whatever. Super don't care.
I haven't listened to the track yet. I've avoided it. I've saved it for.
All right.
I just want to see his reaction to this.
A prize winner is definitely spiraling. You'll love it. The white folks love Drake. First I was arrested, where's the proof of the trial in? Where's the paperwork of the cabinet is filed in? 1090 take would have took all the walls down. The streets would have had me hiding out in a small town. My Montreal connect stand up, not far down. The ones that you're getting your stories from, they all clowns. I am a war general, seasoned in preparation. My jacket is covered in medals, honor and decoration. You waited for this moment, overcome with the desperation. We plotted for a week and then we fed you the information. A daughter that's 11 years old, I bet he takes it. We thought about giving a fake name or a destination. But you so thirsty, you're not concerned with investigation. Instead, you in that Venice studio, it's a celebration. You gotta learn to fact check things and be less impatient. Your fans are rejoicing, thinking this is my expiration. Even the picture you use, the jokes and the medication. The Maybach glove and the drug he uses for less inflation. Master manipulator, you bid on a speculation. You dumb and reactive, nigga, I'm petty with dedication. What about the bones we dug up in that excavation? And why isn't Whitney denying all of the allegations? Why is she following Day Three and I miss the morale? You haven't seen the kids in 6 months, the distance is wild. They leave the heart of holes, underneath pics of the child. Speaking anything with a child, let's get to that now. This Epstein angle was the shit I expected. TikTok videos you collected and dissected. Instead of being on some misdirection. What he said, though, I don't think I can.
You know, but just let me know when we get into the facts. Everything in my shit is facts. I'm waiting on you to return the favor, like.
Okay. Drizzy is locked in. Drizzy is locked the fuck in.
Oh.
I want to go over a lot of what he said, though. I don't think I can just do that. Okay, you know what? I'm going to... Usually I will stop these things while, you know, I'm kind of listening and react, but I kind of wanted to give that a once through. I'm actually going to stop this when things kind of like give me a pause. Okay, I love how he kind of threw it back to Euphoria a little bit there and, you know, kind of like flipped that line on him with the, you know, the actor spiraling, so on and so forth. I thought that was a smart way to kind of... Lines to paper the street down, in the song. And we fed you the information. All right, we got to pause here. This is a really important point in the song. Drake responding to multiple different things being thrown at him right now. You know, most importantly, this idea that like Kendrick knows people either directly or indirectly who are part of Drake's team, who have information. OVO's working for him. He's getting fed info. He's on the inside. Drake should be afraid of everybody around him and so on and so forth. And Drake is claiming, you know, again, he's general status. There's no such thing. Nobody's breaking. Everyone's standing up. And on top of that, we fed you false information that you put into your tracks. And he specifically later references the 11-year-old girl. Now, with that being said, this is something I've been seeing like a lot of Drake fans throw out onto the internet as of late. Is like, oh, he lied to Kendrick and Kendrick just put it in the song without any proof and so on and so forth. And as of right now, there's nothing.
That's exactly what Emery did.
Outside of what guys are just saying over beats to prove anything that's being said in either direction. However, I do have to kind of call bullshit on this. And I'm not saying that Drake has to be lying here. I'm not saying it's guaranteed Drake is lying. But if it was me, in fact, I think if it was any of you, I think any sensible person, especially with Drake kind of framing himself, was like, yeah, we planned it for a week. And you guys didn't even do the research. You just take anything that's said to you, so on and so forth. You don't have the foresight to this and that and the other thing. Like, did you not have the foresight to, what, screen cap the DMs, record the phone calls? Like, that would have immediately been the first thing that I did after the release of Meet the Grams. Like, I wouldn't even put out a track. I would have put up that fucking DM screenshot. I would have put up that email. I would have put up that phone call. Whatever way you are feeding this information to this man, I would have uploaded that to the internet immediately.
I actually kind of agree with him.
Yeah.
The song was fucked and stupid. Yeah, that would have been like kind of good.
That shit, doing that would have cooked him way more than any song. Yeah. Like, yo, you just wasted your time. Suck my dick. Play it, bitch.
Yeah. All right. Well, wait, did this fucking work? It did. Okay.
Ooh.
Good.
I was hoping you were going to click on that so we could see what you'd been downloading.
No, it's fucking somebody said they wanted a clip of Tom saying the N-word thing. That my name is N on Bridges yesterday. And this.
Oh, no way. Yo, just a heads up. You might have fucked up some perms when you pulled everyone out and put everyone back in.
Oh, really?
Yeah, bro.
What do you mean?
Well, let me put it this way.
Okay.
You got it?
Yep.
Alright. There'd be some people who's got soundboard who should be included.
Alright, fair. Got it.
Alright, bro. Have a good sleep.
Alright, later, bro.
I'll dip. Laters.
Bing. All right. I'm going to bed. Tired. I'll be back on tonight, hopefully. I don't know how long I'm going to be on tonight because I tomorrow have to be to work at 11 a.m. But I'm going to watch that Destiny stuff tomorrow. That shit should be funny.
Like, hello, honey, how you doing?
Oh my God, you're awake.
Out with me today.
You're actually awake. You got push to talk on?
Sorry, I've been playing Overwatch.
Word.
In my defense, I don't know anything about this rap thing. When like Emery was like arguing about it, I just had no fucking idea what was going on.
Fair. This week I have to go over the Destiny thing tomorrow because that's gonna be too good. It has to be. And then instead of going over the lyrics debate with Brittany, I'll just go over my stream that I missed.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, I'll go over my stream that I missed and do that.
That's perfect, because I didn't watch that either or pay attention to it. It's like Philly and all them coming in.
Yeah. And I've heard very good things. I've heard really good things. And I haven't fucking listened to it yet.
Oh, really? Like it gets like super spicy or something?
I don't know. I just heard it was entertaining and good. But yeah, I'm going to do those two things this week. And open the booster box with detox. But yeah, I'm ending my stream. Later.
All right.